runner-up for this year's 99 Senior Kerry County Football Championship Final. Well, indeed, this has brought about a very unusual pairing, and a pairing that nobody would have expected to be in this final at the beginning of the year. John Mitchels have not won a Kerry Senior Championship since 1966. Up to that year, no club could match Mitchell's record in Kerry Senior Football Championship, both in the number of titles won or in reaching the final stages of the Senior Championship. Well, Laune Rangers on the other hand, well, they celebrated their centenary year in splendid fashion in 1988. This year they hope to celebrate the centenary of their first Senior County Championship victory by again annexing that coveted trophy. Indeed, since those heyday days when Laune Rangers dominated the championship in 1889, 1890, 92, 93 and 1900, they have featured in but one final, and that was in 1911. So both teams today, 78 years since Laune Rangers won the title, 23 since Mitchell's won the title. In our video production, we hope to visit both camps, bring you previews and views from the players, the mentors, officers in both camps. We hope to visit the county, get the interview from very well-known faces. So sit back now and enjoy this video and enjoy this video production. So as we begin our match preview, we head first, as you can see, for the town of Killarney and the Mitchells Club. So the John Mitchells Club, here it is, set in the aptly named John Joe Sheehy Road here in Killarney. Just about a week to go before the game, players gathering on this evening for training, and we will move in now and get the views of some of the players, some of the officers and many of the people involved in this very, very good club. The GA club have won the Kerry Senior Football Championship on a total of 10 occasions, and before we begin our interview here tonight, we thought we'd take a quick look down memory lane and we'll give you a look at the photographs of those teams who have brought 10 senior titles to this club.
Here at the Mitchells Club, and for Lee was Noel Doc Connolly, Vice Chairman of the Mitchells Club, and I put it to Noel that it was a great achievement for Mitchells to be in the county final on Sunday.
Well, at about last April, we were siding the club one night, and we were hoping if we got over the first round, it would be brilliant, but now it's out of all bounds, out guy, being in the county final.
The fact that you are midways down the chart in the County League and that Laune Rangers are on top of the County League chart, does that have any significance going into the County Final on Sunday, Noel?
No, League and Championship are a way different. Two different ballgames altogether.
Now, in the League earlier on, I believe that you actually defeated Laune Rangers, is that right?
Yes, that is correct.
What kind of a game was that?
Well, we were at our brilliant best that day, and if we can repeat it, and hopefully we will on the day of the final, all things should go well.
Now, you have a number of injury problems at the moment. Some of your star players, your centre half-back, Anthony Gleeson and Martin Dennehy, are both injured. Can you see those taking their places in the first 15 on Sunday?
At the moment, they're very, very doubtful, but hopefully, and we're keeping our fingers crossed in that they will line up.
Now, apart from being a successful club, etc., on the senior front, what does this kind of a success mean to the juveniles in the club?
Oh, well, our juveniles are always active, but I can see more from the outskirts of the town coming down here, joining our juvenile ranks.
Now, finally, Noel, if somebody was to ask you if you were going to win by much on Sunday, what would you say?
Well, a point would be enough, but hopefully 4 points.
Noel,
you've got a marvellous club rooms built here and a fine, very comfortable bar, etc. How has that been going for the club since its inauguration?
Well, I suppose in many sense, we have a business, if you like, at this point. Like any other business, it has its highs and its lows. The success of the senior team, obviously, is reflected in the bar. People want to be associated with success. We're delighted to have them. They're genuine Borby people. And things are looking up the whole time.
Finally, Pat, what are your views as to how the game will go on this Sunday?
So far this year, I missed the first round of the championship. But the determination in Kenmare, the persistence in against Beale, I hope they will culminate in victory against Laune Rangers.
Thank you, Pat. The next man I spoke to in the John Mitchell's club, present chairman of the club, former Kerry under 21 trainer and Kerry minor selected over the years, Buddy O'Grady. I put it to Buddy that they had a very tough task ahead of them on Sunday. Well, Buddy.
I think every country finds money in 50-50 game, and I've been working both as an office and vice the occasion of the day anyway. And I think that the friend that I have for this one, we waited a long time for it, and I've no doubt that we come soon today, but to be very, very, very close.
It's been 23 years since you last won a county title, and prior to that you had won 10 titles. Now, what was the main reason, you think, over the years of the lack of success, would you say, on the playing field in relation to county championship titles? Was it the lack of players or the lack of young fellas coming up along?
Well, I think probably during that period, like, we had a lot of good teams, so we didn't have an awful lot of luck. We lost a lot of promising footballers to another code, and we slipped from Division 1 down to 2, down to 3, and I think we suddenly kind of copped ourselves on, and we realised that we demanded the dedication from the players. So anybody that didn't give that dedication, we didn't ask them to come up and play with the club, and I think that was a wise decision at the time, and I think now we're reaping the rewards of that decision. 23 years is a long time, I admit that, but during those 23 years we had some very good teams. We didn't have an awful lot of luck, and I think our youth policy, especially over the last 8 or 9 years, is now finally beginning to pay dividends for us. We won the under 21 championship in 83, and there's 9 of those left playing on Sunday in the final. we've been very successful at underage, especially under 16, under 12, under 14, the last number of years. And I think that we're now beginning to reap the rewards of this. During the 22 years that we didn't win a championship, the club has been very active, as you can see, my own premises here. And a lot of the energy by the officers at the time was channeled into this. And I think now it's great to be facing a county final with the property and the premises that we've here. And I think that this is only the start for us. We intend to be around for a good few more years.
The fact of the county final going to Killarney, many outside people would feel that it won't have the same atmosphere as having the final here in Ostenstadt Park in Tralee. What are your views on that, buddy?
Well, naturally, we're very disappointed that the match wasn't played in Tralee. For some funny reason, the powers that be seem to consider the Ostenstadt Park above our home venue. And this was probably the case in when the bylaw was brought in 62. Mitchells were in the middle of their record 5 in a row. And I think that they thought that it was an advantage for the club weekend and the sports field above. But as you know, Paddy, at that time, many of the clubs in town didn't have their own fields. And it was probably a wise decision by the county board to bring in the bylaw. But now, just to give you an example, in the last 2 years, we played two games in Ostenstadt Park. One of those was the semi-final against Bale, and the other was a game last year against sometime that the field was out of order here. I think it was against Kilmeade and the County League. And Laune Rangers have played four games in this sports field. And, you know, we don't consider the Ostenstadt Park a home venue to us anymore. But having said all that, we have no objection, naturally enough, to playing in probably one of the finest stadiums in the country, that's Killarney. I think it'll suit our players. The wide open spaces will be a bit of an advantage to us, and we expect to do very well in Killarney.
Now, finally, buddy, if one must ask you to put a score in it, and Mitchell to win the county title in 89, by how much?
I think myself that will be a very high scoring game. I think the midfield battle will be very important. Hopefully Anthony Gleeson will be able to play for us. Of course, if he does, this will be a big plus. We will probably be playing John Higgins as his midfield partner. And I think if anybody deserves to win a county championship medal, it has to be John Higgins. John is 26 years of age. He played his first senior match for Mitchells at the tender age of 15 years of age. And I could safely say that you could count on one hand the number of games that John has missed since 1970, 73, 74. And I think if we win the battle of midfield, I think we'll win the match. And if you ask me to forecast the score for you, I'd be happy enough with a fine victory. But I think it'll be a high scoring game. I could see the score around 211, 28 in favour of John Mitchells.
Going to the game against Laune Rangers, you seem to have a number of injury problems at the moment. How serious are those, Johnny?
Well, Anthony Gleeson and Martin here are quite doubtful at the moment. But we're hoping it's time, really. Just wait and see. It'll be next Saturday before we know if they're fit to play or not.
Now, at the beginning of the year, nobody at all, including the local bookmaker here in Rockfield, would have given you a chance of getting into the county final. You've really created a big surprise. What's the main reason for that, Johnny, do you think?
Well, I think the bookmaker was over-generous in the odds he gave.
What kind were the odds, actually, Johnny?
3-5-1, and I think Laune Rangers were 3-1 favourites in the same opening.
Were those odds taken by a lot of the Mitchells, lads, do you think?
There's quite a share of money on, yeah.
Right, yeah. So he stands to lose a few bucks if Mitchells succeed in winning on Sunday?
I'd imagine so, yeah.
Now, what do you know about this Laune Rangers team?
Not a whole pile on. Yeah, my first time seeing playing this year was here in this park. We played them in the county league. Well, I wouldn't go by that game, because it'd be a different ball game at the Fitzgerald Stadium.
No, you won that game, Johnny, didn't you?
We were quite convinced, yeah.
How was the score in the finish?
1-9 to 3 points.
And what would you fear most about the outfit now, having seen them, this Killarney outfit?
Well, they're fast, and they're a pretty good team. They're together for 2 to 3 seasons now. They've won 2 county leagues. They've won 2 or 3 minor titles in the last 4 or 5 years. So they must be a fairly accomplished outfit now.
Now, the fact of the game being in Killarney, is that an advantage, you think, or a disadvantage to you?
Yeah, I'd say we prefer to be on here in the Ostenstadt Park. I think like when they get to Killarney, it's taking the game away from the people. But we don't mind. We got bids going to Killarney.
Will you have difficulty, John, you think, in finalising your team before the big game? Are there a lot of lads fighting for places at the moment?
Oh yes, it's very keen, all for places, and I'd say it'll be quite a session picking the team, yeah.
But having picked it, you think that you're more than capable of bringing off this county title?
I think we'll get there by a pint or two.
Spoke to was Star Mitchell's player, Donal McAvoy. When I arrived at the club, he was surrounded by the young stars of the club, all looking for his autographs. And when I asked the young lads, is he a good footballer?
Yes!
Is he one of the best?
Yes!
Well, Donal, how do you feel the game is going to go on Sunday?
I don't know, I think it's 50-50, like, you know, you need to kick the ball in at the end, I think, but I know I'm very hungry for success now, like, and it's been 23 years waiting for it. I know Laune Rangers are waiting longer, like, but I think we wanted more, and we trained very hard for it, and we're determined to bring back the cup back in 3, I mean.
And you think you're capable of doing it?
More, I think so, yes, because we won all our games. We beat Kilmare and Bale, like, you know, and we had to come from behind, like, and we're a much better team than we showed in the last couple of games, like, and I think we're all due a blinder, and I think Sunday we'd be keen up enough, like, give a good performance.
Okay, Don, the best of luck to you. Who's going to win the game on Sunday, lads? Dennis Fitzgerald, team trainer of this John Mitchell team, in his very first year having taken him to a county final. Well, at the beginning of the year, I'm sure, Dennis, this would have been one of your aims. Was it more of a dream than a hope?
Well, at the start of the year, we set our aim on doing well in the championship, and we weren't really concentrating on the county league that much, you know. So I don't think it has come as any surprise to the fellas close to the team that we've reached the final, you know.
Now, at what stage in your campaign or in your earlier game did you feel that you had a squad capable of getting to the county final?
Well, we've been trying out players in different positions all year, and I think really after the first round out in my van, I felt that we could go a long way then, you know. We gave a good showing that night, good commitment and good will to win, so I thought that we were looking good then, you know.
Now, some people would say the fact that you've already beaten Laune Rangers and beaten them rather comprehensively in the county league, that you're a far better team than them.
I don't think you can compare the league and the championship. It's just a different kettle of fish completely. We played extremely well here in the league, and they played badly, not up to their normal standard. But it's nice to have a victory over them at the same time.
Now, many people would say that your win over Bale was a big surprise. Would you agree with that?
I wouldn't think so. I thought we were going to beat Bale. We were fairly confident going out, and we stuck to our guns and we came for us in the night.
Now, finally, having seen Laune Rangers in action, what would you fear most about their type of play and the players they have?
Well, I don't fear Laune Rangers. I mean, they're a good side and we respect them, but we certainly don't fear them, you know. We'll take it as it comes in the day, and hopefully at 5 or 5:30 we'll have the silverware with us.
Could you see it being an unbelievable week here with the cup to come back to the clubhouse? People wouldn't go to work for a fortnight thereabouts.
I'd say it could be a fairly rough week, all right.
And a rumour has it there's one man up in Rock Street hoping that Laune Rangers win. That's the local bookmaker. Would that be right?
But there's a man standing over there, and I'd say Colin McLaughlin won't be too pleased to see him on Monday.
Okay, then it's the best of luck to you, and thanks for coming over to
thanks
us.
Thanks very much.
About your forthcoming county final, any bit nervous beforehand?
No, not.
No, you've been involved with the Mitchells for a good number of years and played many games with them, etc. Would this be one of the highlights so far of your career as a player?
Yes, of course, yeah.
At the beginning of the year, did you feel that you were capable of getting this far?
Well, I thought in the last 3 years, I thought we'd a team to get there, but this would be a really bit of luck. We got there this year, yes.
Now, you've already played against Laune Rangers and you've already beaten them in the county league. How do you rate them as a footballing side?
Great. They're a very good team and you're all very well balanced and all that.
The fact of the game being in Killarney, it's a big field and you've two young sides. Do you think it's going to suit both teams?
Yes, exactly.
Now, finally, John, if you were asked to put a few points in it and on the score on Sunday, Mitchell's to win by?
3 points.
Okay, John, the best of luck.
Thanks.
Two lads fresh from the casualty ward being called here in Mitchell's this coming week, the invalids. Well, first of all, Martin, how is your injury treating you at the moment? Are you still quite sore in the hamstring?
Very sore. And the care I was not connected, she said that really is finding the treatment, I think. But I just have to keep fingers crossed.
Are you hoping to make the game on Sunday?
Oh, yes, I'm hoping to make it, all right. So just hopefully, just have to keep getting treated and hope for the best in the game.
Are you looking forward to the game?
Yes, I'm looking forward to it enough.
Do you think you're capable of winning it?
If our backs play well in the day, we get going to centre field, I'd say our forwards should do the business.
Now, are you capable of... Some people say you're going to go for a scoring record if you're playing of approximately 12 points. Is that possible, do you think?
Oh, no. I wouldn't be going for that at all. I'd just take the scores as they come from that day. I'm going up for no records once you win, I don't care.
And can you see yourself turning up here for a week of celebrations if you do win, Martin?
Oh, yes.
It could even go on long, you think?
It could.
Anthony, how's your injury at the moment? You had a very unfortunate injury in your last county league game against Gaeltacht.
Yes, it's still very sore at the moment. So I come down tonight and do two laps of the boys and just bear everything, but still sore and doubtful at the moment.
Now, what has your doctor and your physiotherapist etc. said?
At the moment, doubtful, but I have to go back to the doctor next week and see what he says, and we'll take it from there then, whatever he says, whatever he advises.
But you're hoping to make it?
Hopefully, yes, it'll be nice to make it.
With me is Rory Kilgannon, the club secretary and also club goalkeeper. Rory, do you find it hard to do both jobs, be both a player and an officer of the club?
It can be very difficult at times, yeah.
What's the hardest aspect of it?
Time, basically. The involvement in the football takes a lot of time this year.
Had you any trouble allocating the other and final tickets for this year?
I don't think we saw too many, so we've no problem.
The chairman took those probably at the beginning, did he?
Yeah.
Before they ever came to the club.
I don't think we ever saw them.
Right. Well, anyway, getting back to the game, Rory, how do you expect it's going to go on Sunday?
It's a difficult thing to forecast. Obviously, we're optimistic. It wouldn't be good to be pessimistic. And we have a 50-50 chance. We have the same chance as Laune Rangers have.
And you think if you had a bit of luck on the day, that you'd possibly just get there?
If I think our injuries pick up and we have a full team, I think we have a good chance of winning it.
Team captain of John Mitchells. I was reading in the programme, John Joe, for this county semi-final where a record is hoped to be set if Mitchells win this county title on Sunday next. You might tell us a bit about that.
That's correct, yeah. My grandfather, John Mitchell, he captained the Wayne Mitchells team in 1929. My father, Niall, captained the Wayne Mitchells team in 1959. So the 30-year cycle now, third time round, would be 1989. So if our good captain, Mitchell, Sunday week,
Now, at what stage during the present campaign, John Joe, were you made aware of that particular record? I'm sure you knew about it previously, but...
I didn't, to be honest with you. I didn't. I think the first time that I saw it was in the programme for the team air match. First time that I knew about it,
Right.
It hadn't been mentioned previously to that.
Now, do you feel that puts any bit of pressure on you, or do you take any notice of the fact that that's just one of those things, do you reckon?
Just one of those things. Being captain of this present team was a very easy task, believe me. Hopefully I'll go for the cup then afterwards. That's basically it.
And if that's the case, a rumour has it that no Mitchell's player will go to work for a month. Is that possible, you think?
Possibly even longer than that.
Okay, John Joe, the best of luck to you on Sunday.
Thank you very much,
I have the two O'Donnell twins, famous faces here in the Mitchell's club. On my left I have Jim, and on the right I have Frank. Well, first of all, Jim, I'll come to you and ask you, how does it feel to be playing in your first ever senior county championship final on Sunday next?
Well, we raced as our second senior final because 6 years ago we played on the 3-1 team. That's where victorious. So for us, I mean, this is our second senior. So I'd say most of the team are looking rightly forward to it now and hoping for the best. And with a bit of luck and today, things go right. I think we'll be pulled off.
Your father had a very long association with the game, isn't that right?
That's right, yeah. He played back in the 50s for Kerry and for the great amateur team as well.
Now, how does it feel to have your brother Frank playing with you on the team? Does it mean there's a lot of football talk takes place in your house, both morning, noon and night? Frank, he seems to be passing that one on to you.
It's a day we've had trouble renting, so we can all back each other up anyway. So it's taking water.
But he wouldn't be meant to start a fight now, in fairness, I'd imagine.
Well, we'd be the last to start the fight anyway.
Now, how do you feel about playing in this game on Sunday? Any bit nervous at all about it?
Oh, about it, nervous. Like, it would be natural for me to be nervous.
Even at this stage now, do you feel it kind of coming on? Or?
Well, I feel gradually coming on day by day, like getting closer. Looking forward to it, Mr. Dodd.
Have you trained hard for it?
Oh, never for so. We're hoping out for the best, like, smile with the luck in the day. And we can do that, like, right there.
And you've chosen the rumour that you have seen fungi?
Well, I'm doing a bit of therapy there for the last 3 weeks, swimming there, I have a bad leg. And myself and fungi, we come together.
And you found him, have you found him, that he's been a big influence on you?
Oh, might, yeah.
Okay, lads, the best luck to you on Sunday. Thank you for that. Bambury here on my left. Colm, how are you feeling about this big ball game?
Not too bad.
And
I cut it anyway.
Are you hoping to be maybe called in at some stage and maybe even be picked beforehand?
Well, the team's been picked, so we'll play for you and we'll go for the best.
John Dowd, how are we feeling, John?
Yeah, very well. Fit.
They're calling you the oldest swinger in town, would that be correct?
Around a while, alright.
Around a good while. You think, John, you're capable of bringing it off?
Pardon?
You think you're capable of bringing it off?
I should think so. We've been this far also.
You beat him well in the county league game earlier in the year. Will that have any bearing on the game on Sunday, do you think?
Well, I don't think you can read too much into county league games, but it was a good psychological boost, and I think proved to us that we're capable of beating him. And I think we'll do it again when it matters.
Couple of pints?
Yeah, I don't think there'll be any more than that in this, but one will do.
James, flown in to Farnham for a direct from England. How are you feeling about it?
Feeling good. It'll be tough, but I think we'll take them. We tried hard in the league, but it's different now for championship, but I think we're good enough.
Well, the head barman, Mr. Dan, how are you feeling about it?
Not too bad for you.
Now, a rumour has it that if you win, that you're refusing to work for a couple of weeks. Is there any truth in that rumour?
A week, you know.
At least a week. With PA, I would imagine.
Oh, PA, without a doubt.
Were you playing the last day against him in the county league game?
I was, yeah.
How did you find him, even though you beat him well in the day?
Far as a filly, fast me. The best that you're not for this, yeah. Hopefully we'll win.
What are the chances, you think, of bringing the title back to Mitchell?
A really good chance. Once we keep the head and play our type of football, we'll do alright.
Has the spirit been good in training?
Very good. A good turnout every night. We're always putting in the work. So
has it been hard?
Very hard. We've been hard all right up to next week. We'll tone it down a bit.
It'll be toned down coming up to the final couple of days. What will be the hardest day coming up? Do you think will Saturday be the hardest day with the nerves building up, etc.?
Oh, everyone will be very nervous, I'd say. Everybody. Once we get out on the field, everyone. Treat a game in hand. After that, we'll just hopefully win it.
Johnny Kelleher, nephew of Ger Power and son of trainer Johnny Kelleher. Any truth in the rumour that Mitchells are expecting to win by about 7 or 8 points?
No, it's 7-1. That's a 7-1 single anyway.
Have you found the training hard?
It was tough right last week. Starting to ease off now then.
And you feel you're in tip-top shape?
I feel fairly fit anyway.
And you think you can bring the title back?
I think we can. That's a lack of commitment anyway.
Dowd, brother of Teddy Dowd, Robert, where at this point in time is Teddy? Is he out of the country?
No, he's up the country. He's in Dublin.
Is he coming? Has come back for the county final?
Oh, definitely.
Back to see the game. He won't be playing?
No, won't be playing at all. So, unfortunately, no.
Your father is a selector on the side and is away at the moment.
That's
but
right.
What are your own views as to how the game will go?
I think it'll be very close for you. Point of two, I'd say. We separate both teams. Hopefully, from Mitchell's with.
You're looking forward to it?
Much so.
Are you the nervous type?
No, not really, no.
To knock a shake out of you?
No, not a thing.
Now we move along here to the youngest man on this John Mitchell's team. They tell me a big hit with the ladies, Kieran Moynan, winner of All-Ireland Vocational Medals with both Kerry and his own school here in Tralee. Kieran, how do you feel playing in your first ever county final for your loved club, the Mitchells?
No, but sorry.
A bit nervous, are you?
Yeah, sorry. Even though.
But the fact of having played already now with Kerry Vocations, the fact of having played in an All-Ireland final with your school, do you feel that has helped you in any way to overcome the nerves?
It's nothing like it.
It's nothing like it.
No, I'm delighted to be in it. Let's go with it.
How have you found the spirit now here in training with the lads?
Unbelievable.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Has the training been good?
Very good.
And
everything's been covered, like.
You feel that you can bring it back?
Nobody's saying we want to, yeah.
Best of luck to you. Here with us, Tommy Kearns, who is a sub on the panel. Tommy, and they tell me here tonight in Mitchell that the spirit amongst the subs is fantastic. Is that right?
That's very good. Yeah.
Would you like to get a call in at some stage yourself?
I would, yeah.
Can you see Mitchell's bringing the cup back here realistically on Sunday night?
Definitely.
You think it can be done?
Cup for points anyway.
have John O'Shea, one of the famous faces here in the Mitchells Club, as darkness falls here and the rain beginning to come down upon us. Well, John, tell me, what are your greatest memories over the years here, having been involved with the Mitchells Club in many great games?
Well, it's a great thrill for the lads to be back again. It's 66 since we were there last, and this squad is every bit as good as our crowd. They always say the older guys were better, but I see this lad, these bunch here, are every bit as good. They put in the effort. I think with the determination, the spirit that they have, I don't see any reason why they can't beat this Laune Rangers squad.
Did you think at the beginning of the year that it was possible that they could get into the county final?
Well, honestly, I didn't.
Right.
But I knew with the grit and determination, the buyers knew they had to put in the hard work, and they have put in over the last number of years, and now it's coming to bear fruit. And hopefully, if they get the breaks, there's much between any of the two teams, but I think if they get the breaks on the day, that they could bring the cup back to Tralee.
Former chairman of the Mitchells Club, Ted Fitzgerald, and Dennis Mannix. Well, lads, you were involved with the club for quite a number of years. First of all, yourself, Dennis, were you surprised that Mitchells have reached this year's county final?
A bit surprised. Obviously, we were very lucky in Kinmare, scraped out of Kinmare, lucky against Beale in the semi-final. But hopefully Lady Luck will stay with us and we'll go the whole way and bring back the silverware to Mitchells, or the Yellow Road as we call it.
Killarney have a good team though, Dennis, you'll have to admit.
Killarney always had good teams. From juvenile up, they always were to the forefront of Kerry football and the juveniles. They're doing great work with the juveniles, and obviously it's paying off with the juvenile programme they had down through the years. We wish them the best of luck on Sunday week, and hopefully we'll be victorious then.
Well, Ted, how do you feel it's going to go yourself?
Well, I've no doubt that the Mitchells are going to bring back the championship to the street here after 23 years. Like Dennis, but I'm not as surprised as Dennis was. I think the last number of years we've been very unlucky that we've had a fine bunch of players, great character, and I think that what we need was to get them together and get the proper attitude. I think we have that today. We have good trainers and good selectors, and I think that an awful lot of decisions on the sideline have been very important in our getting to the final this year. And this is very important when you have a good team. I think we may have been lucky in our games in Kinmare and in the last day against Beale, but I think in any championship the Mitchells ever won, we seem to be lucky. And I think I have no doubt that, like all other Mitchells teams, we'll be very hard to beat in the final. And even though it's disappointing that we're not playing here in Tralee, in our hometown, and a lot better atmosphere, I think that the field in Killarney will suit our players as well. I think we've a team that can run onto the ball. They're young and fast, and I think I have no doubt at the end of the day we're going to win. I think we're up against a strong opposition. I suppose the county would make us the underdogs. But I have no doubt myself that we have a character in this team that we haven't had for many years, and I think they'll bring the cup back to the Mitchells where it rightly should be. Thank you.
Very well-known faces, I suppose they need no introduction, Shawnee Burrows and Derry Shea. Well, first of all, Shawnee, what are your views on the forthcoming county final? Can you see it coming back home here?
Well, the lads have trained very, very hard, and we have a couple of injury problems, but I've no doubt that they'll be ready for the final. And with the preparation they've put in, I can't see us losing this final.
What, at the beginning of the year, what would have been your main ambition, looking on it, what was going on in the club for the team to have achieved in the coming year?
Well, over the last number of years, the players were there. Probably a little bit of lack of commitment was missing. This year, I think they're giving it their all, and they've proved that they're a team as good as any other team, as good as any other team county. And on Sunday week, I think they've proved the best.
Well, coming over to you, Derry, would you agree with that?
Yes, I go along with Shawnee's comments there. The start of the year, our first ambition was to stay up in Division 1, which we're still fighting in there. But coming up to next Sunday's game, I think Bobby will win this one. We're hungry for a championship, and the commitment the lads have given all the year is fantastic. We have great players, we have county stand-up players, and we've got a sideline there of selectors with Johnny Kelleher and Teddy Dowd and Dennis and Buddy in behind them. Like, I think we have a great bunch there on the sideline. Like I said, we have county stand-up players, like, and this is the time now that they should be coming through. And I have no doubt Sunday week that we'll capture this championship.
There we have the views from the John Mitchells GA Club here in Tralee. The time is now 5 to 8. The time is ticking and ticking before this county final. And as you can see for yourself, both the rain is falling and darkness is falling. And if you find your picture getting a little bit dark, well, have a chat with the man above. Our next port of call will be Killarney.
So here we are on the banks of the Laune in Killarney on the Tuesday evening before the county final, a town which is alive with football excitement this week. The buntings, the flags are everywhere. First man I met on my travels here was Killarney chairman Jerome Conway, and I asked him how he felt about his team being in their first county final since 1911.
Well, Paddy, 1911 obviously is a long time ago, and the appetite for a championship victory has been whetted in the intervening years. The basis of this team was formed in 1971 when we won the county on the 12th championship. We won the following on the 12th championship. We won the 12th championship for the following 2 years as well, and then in 1977 we won the county minor championship. All this was geared towards a county senior championship victory in the centenary year of the GA in 1984. Unfortunately, 1984 came and passed without such a victory. We then geared the team towards winning the championship in 1988, which was the centenary year of the club. Unfortunately again, our defeat by Desmond's in that year in the championship caused great disappointment. However, 1989, which is the centenary year of our first county championship victory, has arrived, and we are delighted to be in the final. It has meant a tremendous lot to the club to be in the final. The hype among the young lads around the town is now concentrated on our senior players, and the likes of Joe Shannon and Pierce Bendeville, James Sheehan, Paddy Sheehan, Tom Johnston, Tim Fleming, Gerald Murphy are all on the lips of the youngsters in the schoolyard.
Obviously, Jerome, to get to this stage in the county final, it cost a lot of money and training and so on and so forth. How have you succeeded, or have you succeeded in getting sponsors now in your campaign?
We have been delighted with the way that the business people in the town and the companies in the town have rallied to our aid. The credit union, the local credit branch of the credit union, have sponsored tracksuits for the players. AIB, through their relationship with the county board, have given jerseys and holdalls. Eddie O'Donoghue Insurances gave us the togs, and Mike Larkin gave us the socks for the final. Other businesses in the town, such as O'Shea's, Langford Street, Mrs. Lyons of Dunalton, the Red Fox, Pat O'Sullivan Beaufort, have given us generous sponsorship. The local factories, Klinge, have been very generous, and also Liebig. Fexco have been very generous, and the Bank of Ireland.
On the Mitchells from Tralee, who have a great tradition in the county championship, having won a title last back in 1966. Now, how do you feel about taking them on? Do you feel it's a very tough task ahead?
Obviously, we respect the Mitchells. They have a great tradition in county championship football, but we don't fear them. In recent years, we have beaten them in the league. Last year and the year before, we beat them comprehensively in the league. This year, they turned the tables on us, and we were beaten 1-9 to 3 points in Mitchell's own pitch. This defeat was a bit of a setback for us, and we will be seeking to set the matter straight on Sunday.
Now, rumour has it around Killarney this evening that if it happens the cup comes back here for the first time in 100 years, that all schools in the town are closing for a week. Is that right, Jerome?
Not officially, but unofficially anything can happen. The reception that Danny Cahill received when he brought the Tom Arkham Cup to Killarney last year was heartwarming, to say the least. It was outstanding. And I expect if the Bishop Byhan crosses the lawn on Sunday evening, that reception will be outdone over again.
Third year as secretary of the Laune Rangers Club, did you realistically believe at the beginning of 89 that you could actually get into this year's county championship final?
At the end of 88, I didn't think so. But at our AGM this year, I never saw such a large crowd at it. We had 175 people at it. And there was a big furore about success, and I think what came out of that meeting was a fierce determination to win the championship. One, we felt for the last few years that we could have won it, and we felt that we let ourselves down on occasions. But this year, at that AGM, we really made up our minds. And shortly afterwards, we had a players' meeting, and the players were told what was required of them, and they told us they were prepared to do it. And we set our priority this year for one thing, the county championship. We'd won two county leagues, and we said this year we'll go for the big one. And after that, then, I felt we could do it.
Now, you were playing the Mitchells, and you already played them in this year's county league, and they gave you a fairly comprehensive enough hiding on that particular occasion.
Right.
Is that a good thing, do you think, from your point of view, going into this final?
It's not a bad thing. I wouldn't mind that, because going through the last 2-3 years, we've had these days, and I just hope next Sunday is not one of them. Last year we had it against Desmond in the championship, and I think against Swan, the county league as well. This year we had it against, as you say, Mitchells.
Right.
So we have a bad day now and again. I think just against Mitchells we had a bad day this year.
So finally, Tommy, are you more hopeful than confident of bringing the trophy back here on Sunday evening?
I'm quietly confident.
You have been involved with this bunch of lads really since they were playing at the age of under 12 football, is that right?
That is right, Paddy, yes. In 1972, when we started off, we won our first under 12 championship, and I've been with them ever since, right up through the line. And in all those years, I could see the potential that's, you know, that there was a county championship in them at some stage. We didn't know when we'd make the breakthrough. We were hoping in 84 that we'd get it, but we lost some of our players due to immigration, and we just had to wait to now to get into a final.
Now, you have two sons as well that will be playing in the county final. That must mean that there's a lot of football spoken in your house at the moment, is that right?
Well, there's a share of football spoken in it, yes, at the moment. There is indeed, yeah.
Now, you know, did people here in the town, do you think, at the beginning of the year, did they give you a chance of getting into the county final?
Yeah, I think they did. I think last year, you know, we didn't play up to our potential against the Castleisland Desmonds, and, you know, people at the start of the year asked us what were our intentions this year, and our priority this year was the county championship.
So having said that, Liam, do you feel confident of bringing the trophy back here on Sunday evening?
Yeah, Paddy, I feel quite confident. I think it will be a close game. There won't be an awful lot in it at the end of the hour, like a point or two, but that would do me.
Very active club here in Laune Rangers, and I believe that you've already played at club level this year. In this will be your fifth county final on Sunday in 89, is that correct?
That's correct, Paddy. Yes, we've been in the under 12, 14, 16 and minor final already. Now we're on Sunday, with the help of God, we're going for our fifth final, and we'll cap the year with the biggest of them all, I presume, by winning the county senior championship.
Now, with so many teams involved and with such a very active club, it must cost a lot of money to run the club, we'll say, from on an annual basis.
It does indeed, Paddy. We're very thankful to local sponsors here in town, with jerseys for the young fellas and togs, socks and the usual, because as you know, the expense of running a club the size of this is enormous. With the size of the club we have, you'll be looking for at least 10,000 to 12,000 a year. That's to cover buses, transport expenses, field maintenance, footballs, the works. So you would definitely need the sponsorship from locals to keep you going.
Now, the Mitchells have a great tradition in the senior football championship, and you've seen them play quite a few times. Now, what would you fear most about them in this final on Sunday?
I suppose one of the main things you would have to fear is their tradition in senior championship football, that they won't die easy. You'll never have them beaten till the final whistle, because they'll think of teams that are gone before them. Any Tralee team carries tradition with it, and they have an attacking flair, much the same as ourselves, but hopefully on the day we should be the better and come out on top.
Trainer of the Killarney minor team, you won the county final just over almost a week ago. Will that be a big boost, do you think, for the lads going into the senior final on Sunday?
Well, we think it would anyway, because the feeling in the club is that we're hungry for success. We're hungry for success at senior level. And the double, which we said and we thought would be on, should be on, and it is on at the moment. I think it will set great high spirits and good morale for the whole club. We had great backing from the seniors at all the games, and I feel that it has set the right trend anyway for the coming from the next Sunday.
Will there be a lot of pressure on your star minor player who's playing at full forward, I believe, again on Sunday, Billy Sullivan, the fact that having performed so well in that game and having scored actually 2 goals and 7 points?
Yes, Billy is he's been scoring 2-6, 2-7 consistently. He's a Kerry minor. He was a Kerry minor last year. Pressure? I don't think so. I think he's one of the very, very few players that when the pressure does come on, he's able to answer the calls. He's very, very unique. He's certainly the best underage player I've ever seen playing football. But realise one thing: he is just a minor. I wouldn't wish anybody to think that Billy is the awesome, powerful player he is. He's just 18 years of age, and that has to be taken into consideration. I expect Billy to play well. I think Killarney will suit him. But he's just part of a team, one member of a team. And if we're going to win next Sunday, it's going to be the 15 players that will have to play well.
Finally, John, what would you fear most about the Mitchell side? You've seen them and you've played against them over the years.
Well, on this point, I have to stop letting my heart rule my mind and say that it is the great determination and ruggedness and doggedness of their play. They're very, very tenacious. They hunt everything. They're a typical Mitchells team. They don't stop. They keep coming at you and at you and at you, and they harass and they chase. And to be realistic, I do think that they're going to be difficult to beat. But as against that, we have got the ball players, and I think our experience with players like Joe Shannon, Pierce Prendeville, Paddy Sheehan, Tom Johnson, James Sheehan, and Gerard Murphy is having an exceptional year this year. I think it'll be very, very hard to that all the doggedness in the world won't do Mitchells, because you just cannot close down so many talented players that are on the senior team.
Any team trainer of the Laune Rangers team here in Killarney, I believe, Noel, that there's a bit of a tie-up between yourself, this present team, and the team that won the county championship last back in 1911, is that right?
Yeah, that's right, Paddy. My grandfather, Paddy Foley, played on the 1911 team.
Now, you took over charge of the team back in 1983. At that particular point in time, what was your main aim or your main ambition?
Well, to start with, my main aim was to win a mid-Kerry championship, and we won the first year. I had charge 1983, and we have won every year since.
That's been a fantastic achievement. That's a total of 6 mid-Kerry titles, isn't that
right?
That's
6 in a row, and we're still in this year's competition. We're in the semi-finals. It's not finished yet this year.
Did you actually play the Mitchells in 83 as well in the championship?
We did, we did the first year. First county championship was against John Mitchells.
And you played them on and off in the county league since?
We've played them a few times, last 3 years anyhow.
How do you rate them as a footballing team?
Yeah, they're a fine team. They're very good fielders and great tryers. You know, they're strong all over the field.
Now, they've already beaten you in this year's county league. Well, is that a good thing, you think, Noel, or a bad thing going into the final on Sunday?
It depends on the reaction of both teams, really, you know. There are two ways of looking at it. If it could give Mitchells great confidence, you know. They have beaten us this year, like, fairly well, and you know, we will have to improve a lot on that performance, definitely. The way we played that day was poor,
and maybe we hit enough there, or maybe Mitchell's could be the team with the players to stop us. You know, next Sunday will tell.
Now, have you found that you've got good commitment from the players? Have you been happy with their commitment to you in training?
Oh, certainly, yes. You know, we've had a few weeks training for this, yes. You know.
Now, the weather here tonight in Killarney is a bad, windy, wet kind of a night. How would those conditions, you think, Noel, suit your players if it were to prevail in Killarney on Sunday?
Yeah. Well, I think windy conditions don't suit any player, you know. It would be the same for both teams, you know. We hope that for the sake of the two teams and spectators here, that the conditions next Sunday will be fine. If they're not, you know, I think it's the same for both teams, you know.
Right. Now, you have trained hard and you have actually had a challenge here pretty recently against the Duhalla team in Killarney. How did you find playing on the pitch?
It was wet that night, I think, you know, and we were beaten by a point, you know, but the pitch itself, you know, the players found it okay.
Now, are you a man that suffers from nerves yourself? Can you see yourself being very nervous in the morning, or?
Next Sunday, maybe. Not yet, anyway.
Now, you have the basis of quite a young squad. You have a mixed age group of players, isn't that right?
We have a nice blend. You know, we have maybe the backbone of the team are in their mid-20s to late-20s, and we have a share of younger players as well, you know, say 18, 19, 20, 21, that way.
Well, having said all that, Noel, you feel quite confident that you can bring the trophy back here for the first time in 100 years?
Well, for the first time since 1911.
11, and it's 100 years since you won it.
I think we'll have to play at our very best, you know. Definitely, we won't win otherwise, you know. We respect Mitchell's, definitely, you know. We will have to play. We'll have to play very well and improve on the way we played against Mitchell's earlier this year.
And if that can be done, then it's possible that the cup will
come. It's possible, yes. You know, it all depends on the form. You know, all championship matches are like that. You know, it depends on who hits form on the day. You know, we're hoping that we will hit form, our best form on the day, and hopefully we will win then. You know.
Peter, you're PRO of the club and you're also captain of the team this coming year. Is it very hard to be both a player and an officer of the club at the same time, do you think?
Well, being PRO of the club, like, you know, it's not too bad. You have to attend the meetings and make up posters and things like that, like, you know, and look after some of the other odds and ends. But this event of being captain, all right, like, you know, the start's here, like, you know, they want a commitment, and if I didn't give commitment, I was going to shoe up the hall and lose the job as captain.
Right.
So it's up to myself then, like, to knuckle down, and thank God anyway it's paid off, and one more hour of football and we can have the Bishop Minor.
Did you find that having to be captain, did you find it helped your own play as well, Peter?
No, not the start of the year. I was playing terrible.
Right.
Nothing went right for me at all, and as I said there, I got to shoe up the hall, I got to keep up the backside from the selectors, and I knuckled down and my players started to come together again.
Now, did you believe at the beginning of the championship that you were capable of getting into a county final?
Yeah, without a doubt. We had the players. We've got a fabulous panel of 27 players. Everybody's fighting for positions, and that was the difference. Like, you know, we had the players, and it was just a case of the selectors getting the fillers in the right positions and working on that. And we're in a county final now, which is great.
And do you feel that you're have more than a 50-50 chance against Mitchell on Sunday?
Yeah, like, you're talking about big time, like, you know, it's going to be an awful experience for everybody in there, like, you know, the big crowd and the big pitch. But our players have got the experience, which we could slightly swear in our side. They have got the experience. So
you're a selector on this present Laune Rangers team. Could you tell us how long you've actually been involved with the club in that capacity?
Nearly 10 years. 1980, I took over as trainer, and I trained for 3 years, and I'm off and on since then.
Now, it's a very demanding job. People think that, you know, it's a great little number to have, but it's very demanding, isn't it, being a selector on a successful side?
Oh, it is, yeah. You have to give it everything. You have to be at all training sessions, and you have to give your full commitment to it.
Now, did you have difficulty in with such a large panel of players in picking your final 15 for this county final on Sunday?
Well, we have a panel of 27 at the moment, which we like as it's very hard, like, because we have a lot of players equal to one another, like, and trying to start those forwards and backs, and, you know, it's a demanding job, yeah.
Now, having said all that, do you give yourselves more than a 50-50 chance against Mitchell's on Sunday?
I would give it that slight couple of pints of a difference, like, you know, maybe I think we should take about 3 or 4 pints.
John, are many of your present panel away from Killarney, or are they all available to come training every night?
Well, we're looking in that respect, actually, Padraig, because as far as I know, Tommy Burns was about the only one that was missing all the year, you know.
Right.
He was on holidays for the summer, and he's back with us now. You know, we have all our panel at home now, yes.
That's a big advantage, isn't it?
What is a tremendous advantage, yes.
Now, in the earlier in the year when you played the Mitchells in the County League, what kind of a side had you out that day in comparison to the 15 to take the field on this coming Sunday?
Well, we have a few changes now from that particular day. As far as I know, we have a new half-back line, and we have a couple of changes in the forwards as well. And hopefully that will make all the difference, you know.
Now, having played the Stacks in the semi-final game, did you feel that it was necessary to make some changes for the final?
Yes, it did. We did, yeah. We thought long and hard about it over the past few weeks, you know.
Right.
You know.
Right. Now, the spirit in the camp has been good, John, has it?
It has been great, yeah. Very, very good, yeah.
And how hopeful are you of bringing back this new trophy to Killarney?
Well, we are fairly hopeful, all right, you know, we're there with a good chance at least 50-50, you know.
Involved with the club going back since the early 50s, I believe, is that right?
That's right. I was elected assistant secretary around 1952 or 3, I think it was. We had a hurling club here at the time, and it was going pretty good. And football was about 2 games, I'd say the senior team would have in a whole year, competitive games in McKerry. And in an effort to organise the club and get outside games, we decided to set up a new committee. And I went in, I was secretary to the hurling, so I went in as assistant to the football. Brendan Mangan actually was the secretary that period. And from that on, I've been an officer continuously.
Now, rumour has it that this new cup that's to be presented for this county final victory on Sunday next is supposed to be a magnificent cup. Is that right? You've seen the cup?
I've seen the cup last night in the unveiling ceremony in the Castleisland in Killarney, and it was really, it's fantastic. It's a magnificent cup, and you know, you'd be kind of worried about even leaving it out. I know that it's easy to say we'll take care of it, but if it falls into the wrong hands, certainly damage will be done to it. This cup cost in excess of 6,000 to make, and it was the same man who has made the new Sam Maguire that made it, and he was down in Killarney yesterday to hand it over to the East Kerry board, and he told them, like, that they should be extra careful. He's delighted with the cup himself.
Would you prefer if it fell into the safe hands of the Laune Rangers club than the Mitchells, would you?
That's for sure, like, and we've a good omen in that respect, because even though that the first club to win the old Bishop Mining Cup was a Tralee team, John Mitch at our Cairns O'Reilly's last night, they were pointing out that it would go on in that anyway. Maybe the Mitchell should win it, but I pointed out that we wore the same colour, so that would be the blue and white to be carrying it, and the fact that we in Killarney was an extra bonus to us. And also, anyway, the Cannon Line Cup is already with us, so it is only right that, I suppose, you know, the Bishop and the Cannon will go well together.
Can you see it making a fantastic week here if the trophy comes across the lawn?
I can see it making a fantastic end of a year. We're looking forward to a sharp winter, and I think we're going to have it. It was great to be, you know, when Kerry were knocked out of the Munster final, we were saying to ourselves it's going to be a long winter, but fair play, our minors, first of all, and now our seniors have sharpened it very much. And we're looking forward to the Munster Championship, Club Championship, and also to winning over Slipped in Kerry, and make a real scoop. That's my mid-Kerry, of course, on Sunday. And it's that beyond us, we can do it. I would have fears certainly about playing in Killarney, that's my own personal view, but I'd prefer it wasn't Tralee, but nobody else agrees with me, so I must be wrong.
So here in Killarney this evening, I have with me one of the great supporters that the team have at the moment, Michael O'Donnell. Well, Michael, how are you feeling about this game on Sunday?
I'm kind of happy about it. I'm fully behind them. I think we've got a great team, and if they can play up to the fixation, and if they can play the match as up to 60 minutes, I think we can beat them.
There we have it. The players are now in the dressing room, been spoken to by the chairman of the club, and the team is going to be announced any moment now, sir. So there we leave it from Killarney. We will now travel out and about and get the views of many well-known faces as to how they feel this county final will go on Sunday next.
So for our first comment, we cross over the borders into County Cork, where they are this week celebrating the return of Sam after an absence of 16 years.
Yes, indeed, to the Gaeltacht village of Ballyburn, where new Kerry team trainer Mickey O'Sullivan teaches here in Colossal Gubnaton as a PE teacher and geography teacher.
This is perhaps one of the most evenly contested county finals in a long time. Both teams have had a similar pattern of play up to now. Mitchell seemed to be leave it till the last 10 minutes, till they really started playing against Kinmare and against Beale, whereas Laune Rangers did something similar against Kieran's, St. Kieran's, and against Austin Stacks. Perhaps I think that Laune Rangers are probably more talented, but on the other hand, Mitchell's make up for that with their never say die spirit. And I think it's going to be very, very evenly contested. And I'd nearly go for a draw myself.
Right. Well, I suppose I know a bit more about Mitchell's this year because we played him in the quarter final in Kinmare, and I think we were a bit disappointed after we could have beaten them. But I think their club spirit told in the end, and they just caught us with a goal in the last couple of minutes and held out. Laune Rangers, I don't know a whole pile about either. We haven't played them in county league games or anything like that because we're Division 2 ourselves. But I think it's going to be a very closely contested final. Laune Rangers, or John Mitchell, seems to have something over Laune Rangers in previous games from what I see in the paper. At the end of the day, though, I have a fancy for Laune Rangers, in fairness. However, John Mitchell's looking at their performances in the championship to date, they have, and no disrespect to them, they have a bit of luck on their side. Now, that's not being disrespectful or anything towards them, but I know when we won the championship in 1987, we had a little bit of luck as well, I think. A lot of people in Killarney would say an awful lot of luck, but you need luck to win games, and you need luck to win championship games, and certainly in that regard, Mitchell's have it, you know, and they might carry it through to the final. But at the end of the day, I think my fancy goes for Laune Rangers.
Well, Paddy, I think it's going to be a very close encounter. I saw both semi-finals, and I think they're two very even teams. Probably Laune Rangers have better teamwork. They seem to have forwards that are very well used to playing with each other. Mitchell's, on the other hand, I think have great spirit. As people know down through the years, Mitchell's club always have great spirit when they go on the field. A lot will depend on how the Mitchell's injuries are. If they have a fully fit team, I think it's going to be a very close game, and it'll depend on what team has a commitment on the day. I think Mitchell's might just shade it if they have a fully fit team, but if Anthony Gleeson and Martin Dennehy, they're reported to have injuries, if there's a doubt about any of those, I'd be inclined to go for Laune Rangers.
I think it's going to be a very interesting game, Paddy. Obviously, being a Staxman, we're very disappointed it isn't going to be a local derby. Judging, I suppose, on semi-final performances, Offaly's could have beaten Laune Rangers, and I think Beale could have beaten Mitchell's, but that's the way it didn't work out that way. Two very good footballing teams. When they met in the county league earlier on this year, Mitchell's had a fairly comprehensive win above in Shamford's, and I think that psychologically that would be a bit of a boost to them. But I would see Mitchell's having a bit of a problem with the two injured players. I think if Mitchell's are full strength, I would have a slight fancy for Mitchell's because they're the local team, I suppose, you know. But Laune Rangers have some very good players, Joe Shannon, Timmy Fleming, Billy Sullivan, Ger Murphy. I think it'll be very, very tight, and I think obviously there'll be a lot of tension in that both of them haven't played. I think most of their players wouldn't have played in a county senior final. But I think if the gun is put to my head, I'll go for Mitchell's only just.
It'll be a very close game, really, because watching the two teams play in the two semi-finals, I think whereas both of them played very well, I think that probably Killarney would be that little bit, I would fancy them that little bit, but it'll be definitely be on the day between the who's ever, well, the attitude will be very important. If Mitchells have the right attitude, then they'll win, or if Killarney's attitude is right, they'll win. But I think at the end of the day it will be very close, but it should be a very good game, especially in Killarney where there'll be plenty of space, and hopefully that will be a very good county final.
I think it'll be a very interesting county final, Paddy. I think there's two club teams in it for the first time in a long time, maybe the first time ever. I suppose you'd have to and form a county league form over the last couple of years, you'd have to be fancying Laune Rangers. They seem to have a maybe more balanced team. They seem to be consistently good over the last two or three years. But Mitchell's then, you know, with the great tradition behind them, would be very keen to win. Having got to the final, I think they'll be very hard to beat. Injuries at the moment is obviously a problem for them, and the two players in question are not to form, certainly less their chance a lot. I would think that if I had a fiver, I think I'd probably put on Laune Rangers. I think they have a slightly better chance. I think if the team has played 10 times, I think Laune Rangers probably win 6 or 7. But then on the day, it's a two-horse race, and Fine is a great leveller. And I would think Mitchell will be, they'll fight in their backs, they'll be there till the very end. But I think Laune Rangers will probably have a more balanced side.
I think it's going to be a very open county final. There are certainly two surprise teams. They're not the teams anyone expected to be in the county final. On paper, I think Laune Rangers would obviously be favourites. I think two things militate against Mitchell's. One, the injury situation to probably their two best players. Certainly Gleeson is by far their best player. Now, if Gleeson is out, I really wouldn't give them much of a chance. Secondly, Dinhy is a great player, great free taker. And if you're missing your best player, best all-round player and best free taker, well, you know, the odds are stacked against Mitchell's. Secondly, I was surprised that they dropped John Hegarty, who's an excellent forward. I don't know what's the reason for it. Obviously, there's probably something going on. He struck me as being an excellent forward, and one that would be well suited to Killarney pitch because it's wide open. Laune Rangers probably, like I said, they have probably a better balanced team. Very good forwards in Kerry Minor, Billy O'Sullivan and Timmy Fleming and George Murphy. Fellas were well used to the big time. Like I said, I would be inclined to give my nod towards Laune Rangers, yet Mitchell's, they'll never finish. We should have hammered them off the face of the earth in Kinmare, and yet they pipped us in the end. They have fantastic club spirit and commitment, and a Mitchell's team, to beat them, you want to be 20 times better than them. They will never die up to the last minute of the game. You could be 3 goals ahead and they could still pop in 4. You can never rule them out.
Well, I think this county final will be a novel pairing. I'd say at the start of the year, very few people would have forecast such a pairing. From my own point of view, our own team, Duhallo, we play a lot of teams in Kerry from time to time, and we have played against Laune Rangers 3 occasions this year. And they're one team that I consider very highly. I think they're a fine football team. They have a fine future. They're quite young, and they're a very good combination. As regards John Mitchell's, we met them once this year when we were a bit under strength, and they struck me as being a very forceful sort of a team. Maybe not fantastic individual talent, but great heart and great combination, and physically very strong. Especially I noticed there with John Joe Sheehy now around the centre of the field and half forward. A very strong man, and of course they have some players of Kerry experience. I understand they have injuries which will upset them a bit. And the fact it's in Killarney, I think, will be to Rangers' advantage. We met them in the stadium recently, and they like the open spaces. Another thing about them is that they play very much precise sort of game, and they switch their wing forwards. I noticed there Gerard Murphy, the last time we played him, he switched from side to side. If they can get control of the game early on and get possession, they'll be very hard to beat. But I'd say Mitchell's won't go down easily. They have a great tradition, and I'd say they won't give up this opportunity easily. It's a long time since they've been in the county final.
It's Laune Rangers and Mitchell's in the county league earlier on this year, and they're beaten by both teams. They're two very good teams, very evenly matched. I'd say the Killarney pitch would suit Laune Rangers, but the Mitchell's, they're the type of team that'll never give up until the final whistle. And I'll just say I stick out my neck and I'll go for the Mitchell's.
We visit the Allard Irish Banks, our sponsors here in Tralee, and we'll have a word from their regional manager, Mr. Niall Kelly.
Have you introduced myself? My name is Niall Kelly, regional manager of Allard Irish Banks. This year, Allard Irish Banks, for the first time, are sponsors of the Kerry County Senior Football and Hurling Championships. And I would like, in that capacity, to welcome you to today's match between Laune Rangers and Mitchells. In Anal Irish Banks, we are very proud of our long association with the Gaelic Athletic Association, both nationally and particularly in Kerry, which to me is the home of football. Like yourself, I'm looking forward to today's match. And I think, as a neutral Corkman, I can say safely, may the best team win.
With that final word from our sponsors AIB, the day has at long last arrived and the crowds are pouring in here to Fitzgerald Stadium, Killarney, and it's only a 2:15 as of yet. Trophy for this year's Senior County Championship Final, the Bishop Moynihan Trophy, and here to tell us a little bit about it and where it came from is this year's, or this present Kerry County Board Chairman, Sean Kelly. Well, Sean.
Paddy, as you're probably aware, the old Bishop Moynihan Cup, which was presented by the late Bishop Moynihan in 1953, disappeared about 10 years ago, and there was a replacement cup in use for the past 10 years or so. Most people weren't aware of that. They thought it was still the Bishop Moynihan Cup, but I felt that we owed it to the people of Kerry, we owed it to the Kerry Senior Football Championship, and we owed it particularly to the great image of Kerry football to have a trophy which would reflect that image. So I went to the East Kerry Board at the beginning of the year and I asked them, would they be willing to put up some of the finance for a new cup and to maintain the name of Bishop Moynihan, and they responded in the affirmative. And then we went to various people to find out who would be the best person to make the cup for us, and after searching around we found that the best person would be Des Burden from Kilkenny, who actually made the new Sam Maguire Cup last year. So this cup here is a special design, it's a unique design, and it incorporates many of the wonderful facets associated with Gaelic culture. It has the Celtic designs and engraving, and it has in particular here in front the Kerry crest, which was specially made for it and put into it. It's probably second only to the Sam Maguire Cup in value where Gaelic games are concerned. It's worth £6,000, and probably to replace it you'll be talking maybe about twice that much. So we're very pleased with it, and we hope that it will be respected and that it won't be tossed about and ruined like unfortunately many cups are. It's a solid silver, and it has got the silver engravings here in the back, and I think everything about it is very pleasing, and I think everybody who has seen it has been delighted with it, and we hope that it will enhance further the standard of the Kerry Senior Football Championship.
Sean, the atmosphere here in Killarney today, you know, is absolutely fantastic. Many people spoke earlier in the week, you know, they're taking it away from Tralee, we're taking the atmosphere, but it seems like we're going to have a real bumper crowd here.
Yes, it looks that way, and the weather is perfect. Unfortunately, a lot of false things were said about the taking it away from Tralee. Some people pinpointed me as being doing it as if I was creating the rules myself. But in actual fact, everybody knows the bylaw is there, which says it's played in Tralee or Killarney. The Kerry County Championship from quarter-final stage on is played at neutral venues, and Laune Rangers opted for Killarney. We asked them not to, because we prefer to have it played in Tralee to facilitate spectators and so forth. But they held their second meeting and they decided they wanted to exercise their option to have it here in Killarney, and that was the way it had to be. Stax played here in Killarney a number of years ago. There have been many county semi-finals played here, all neutral venues, and that is the important thing where finals are concerned and semi-finals and so forth. But at the same time, I think there's an excellent atmosphere here. Mitchells understand the position, particularly the Mitchells officials that I spoke to. They understand it. I think, in fact, both teams, because of their positive approach, will actually play much better perhaps here than they might anywhere else.
Sean Kelly, thank you very much for speaking to us, and hopefully we'll have a chat with you after the game again.
Please, Gordon, I look forward to a very entertaining game. Thank you very much, Paddy.
Right, okay, on. So there you have it, as the pipe band are parading down here, the atmosphere, you can see a very, very large crowd indeed up there in the stand. They're huddled in together, and many people felt the crowd here would be very, very small indeed. But my, oh my, there you can see them. Many faces I'm sure you'll recognise, preparing for this county senior final, which will take place now as the East Kerry Donoghue Cup final is about to kick off for the second half. Even as you can see over on the far side, there's quite a good crowd up over on the hill, and many people felt, well, that it would look very, very, very empty there on the far side, but you can see right over across the way it looks to be quite a good crowd. And as I say, there's about a half hour to go to the game yet. The teams now are going to come into the dressing room just as the two teams come out here for the start of the second half, and we really and truly are looking forward to this very exciting 89 county final.
We have in the stand, relaxing before the game, the Mitchells camp and the Laune Rangers camp. The Mitchells camp clad in their green jumpers and the Laune Rangers camp clad in their navy, and they're very, very relaxed looking, and they're going to wait for a while before they actually go out to take the field. But some of the players looking a little bit on the nervous side, other players wondering how it's going to go. In approximately 1.5 hours time, we will know whether the cup will be heading for Killarney west of the Laune River or will be heading for the town of Tralee. Time alone will tell. So there they are, relaxing and taking it easy as the crowd gather in behind them, and the second half of the Donoghue Cup begins here behind us. We are just before the game. We've one of the greatest football supporters, not alone in the county of Kerry, but I suppose in all of Ireland, that man Leo Griffin. Leo, would you be a Staxman or a Mitchell's man?
No idea, Mitchell's man all my life. All my life, been a Mitchell's man.
Now, how do you see this game going today, Leo?
Well, I think we should win fairly handy, I think. And the last outing, of course, today in the league, they only scored 3 points against us. And I think, and that performance alone, of course, the Laune Rangers have 5 changes from that team. We have a few personal changes, like, but I think we should win very comfortably. And I think if this team wins this championship this year, I think we'll be around for a long time.
Leo Griffin, thank you very much.
It is a marvellous day for Kerry football. Look at the crowd. We have 15 or 20,000 people here today. That stand can take 10,000 people and it is nearly full. Look, I'm delighted to be a part of it and I'm delighted to be here. And I hope that it is only the start from today onwards. We'll get our senior team back on the go again for the win of All Ireland.
Donnie, how can you see today's county final going?
I can see it a very close game. I think myself, it's on the day, but I think Laune Rangers might have that little bit of extra. A point or two for Laune Rangers would be my forecast.
Thank you very much, Donnie.
The stage is now set, and any moment the Laune Ranger team, yes, there they come out in the field, led by their captain, Peter Lyons, bursting forward onto the field. They are the favourites for today's game. Yes, indeed, there they are, running out, playing in their first senior county final since 1911. And what a marvellous achievement is it for this team to be here today in Fitzgerald Stadium in Killarney, really clad in the blue and white of the Laune, led by their captain, Peter Lyons, as they move down here to take the goals down under the Dawn Milk. Scoreboard down here on the right, as the crowds have really packed in here to Killarney for what many people would regard as being a very, very surprise venue. But the Mitchells now about to come out in the field. Yes, there you can hear it. The crowd are roaring for them as they make their appearance out onto the field, led by their captain. Here they come, the Mitchells. Nobody expected that this would be the pairing here for this year's Senior County Championship final. But my, oh my, what a turnabout it has been. And the Mitchells have done what nobody thought they could do. They have got into this year's county final. Oh, a marvellous achievement. The crowd are pumping in here now as we watch Mitchell down here, and they're clapping their supporters. Here they come, clapping their supporters, and the supporters up behind us really cheering them on in great fettle. The men from the town of Tralee, last winning a title 23 years ago back in 1966. And in the sport team make their way off the field, the Mitchells right down here on the left hand side, and we'll give you their team as they line out. In goal for Mitchells, their club secretary Rory Gilcannon, 26 years of age. Cornerback wearing number 2, Kieran Minahan, 19 years of age. Number 3, Frank O'Donnell. Number 4, his brother, his twin brother, Jim O'Donnell. The halfback line, Ogie Sheehy, 22 years of age. Number 6, Gunter John Higgins, 26 years of age. And number 7, Robert O'Dowd, 24 years of age. Middle of the field, the 26-year-old James O'Dowd, partnered by the 21-year-old Anthony Gleeson. Half forward line, wearing number 10, 20-year-old Kieran Kelleher. On the 40, the captain, wearing number 11, John Joe Sheehy, and trying to emulate a great family tradition here today by captaining this side. Number 12, 22-year-old Donald McAvoy. Number 13, 29-year-old Nolly Kelleher. Wearing number 14, Larry, they call him, yes, Martin Dennehy, 26-year-old Martin Dennehy. And wearing number 15, John Roach. The only change on the Mitchell side from their semi-final game against Bale is that their corner forward was dropped, and John Roach now takes his position. Down here on the right-hand side, meanwhile, we have the Laune Rangers team with their backs turned towards us, posing for their team photograph, and they line out as follows. In goals, the club PRO and the captain of the team, Peter Lyons, born in England, came home to live in Killarney. He is hoping to take the trophy back to Killarney for the first time in 78 years. The half-back line, the full-back line, wearing number 2. The only change in the Laune Rangers team is Anthony Shannon coming in for the injured Danny Cahill. Wearing number 2, 28-year-old Anthony Shannon. Wearing number 3, 27-year-old Paddy Sheehan. At number 4, 29-year-old James Sheehan. The half-back line, 20-year-old Mark O'Connor wears number 5. 32-year-old Tommy Johnson wears number 6. And 21-year-old Shane O'Sullivan wears number 7. middle of the field, wearing number 8, Joe Shannon, 27 years of age. Number 9, 20-year-old James O'Shea. Number 10, 23-year-old Gerard Murphy. Number 11, 26-year-old Pierce Prenneville. And at number 12, 20-year-old Timmy Fleming. The full forward line, wearing number 20, Paul Griffin. Wearing number 13 and 20 years of age, Paul Griffin. 20-year-old Pat McKenna wears number 14. And wearing number 15, their youngest player out in the field today, 18-year-old Billy Sullivan, captain of their minor team who won the county championship just a week ago this weekend. So the stage is set here indeed for what promises to be, we hope, a very, very entertaining county final. And as the John Mitchells club prepared to come over here on the far side, they have had 10 glorious years. They have won 10 senior county championship titles, 1929, 1937, 1947, 52, 59, 60, 61, 62 and 63. The last title they won was back in 1966, so they have had 10 glorious years. And back in 1929, the captain was John Joe Sheehy. In 1959, the captain was Niall Sheehy. And today, in 1989, the captain is John Joe Sheehy. For today, this senior championship today, it began way back in 1889, and the very, very first title ever was won way back that time by the Laune Rangers Club. Since then, John Mitchells hold the greatest number of titles in the county, having won a total of 10 titles. Laune Rangers have won a total of 6 titles, so today Laune Rangers are bidding to make it 7, Mitchells are bidding to make it 11. Where's it going to be? During the week, the bookies in Tralee were quoting 5 to 6 the Mitchells, 5 to 6 Laune Rangers. Ruddy Buck, the punter's pal in Tralee, was quoting 4 to 6 and 4 to 7 Laune Rangers. You could have got 5 to 4 as late as yesterday on the Mitchells. Well, it has indeed been a marvellous campaign coming forward into this championship, and on their way to this championship, Laune Rangers have scored a total of 1 goal and 34 points. Against them have been scored a total of 1 goal and 21 points. The leading scorers for them were Timmy Fleming, has already scored 13 points. John Murphy has scored a total of 10 points. Young Billy O'Sullivan has scored a total of 1 try. And James O'Shea has scored 3 points. Paul Griffin 3 points. And James Sheehan and Pierce Prenneville have scored 1 point. So out in the middle of the field now, both captains coming to meet each other. The captain wearing number 11 for Mitchells, John Joe Sheehy, and the captain wearing number 1 for Killoglen, Peter Lyons, the PRO. And Peter Lyons works as the Gaelic proprietor. The toss is thrown up now. It looks like Killoglen have won the toss, and they have decided to play, I think, against the wind. Yes, indeed, the wind is blowing down the field here. It looks like Killoglen have made that decision in these very, very early moments. You remember in the East Kerry game just gone before this, Gineve Gwilla came out in the second half, having a very, very strong wind behind them, and it being ahead of Spa, and still did not manage to hold on to their title. Well, the stage is set here. The crowd, I would estimate, it must be close on 20,000 people. Many said we wouldn't have 10. They're tucked into the stand. The stand is full, and right behind us here, as the sun comes out, let's hope it's not affecting your picture. It comes, it goes. On their way to today's final, we have given you what Mitchells have scored, what Laune Rangers have scored. On their way to today's final, John Mitchells have scored a total .232 for and 3 goals and 20 against. Martin Denny is their top scorer with 23 points. John Hegarty has scored 1-1. John Joe Sheehy has scored 1-1. Donald McAvoy has scored 3 points. Noel Kelleher, Kieran Kelleher, James Dowd and Robert Dowd have all scored 1 point apiece, as the teams now prepare to line up behind the pipe band for the annual parade before this marvellous county final. So the teams make their way across here, being led by the pipe band, and it is indeed a very, very proud moment for both clubs today. Both clubs steeped in history, and when I visited both camps during the week, was made very, very welcome indeed by both camps. Mitchells indeed and Tralee felt they were very capable of winning the title, as indeed did Laune Rangers and Killoglen, and they come over here to the far side, and marvellous support from both clubs. I would say every man and woman and child that can be from Tralee, from the Mitchells area, and from Killoglen must be here today. The captain, Peter Lyons, leaping up in the air there. The team's really clad. The Kerry wearing, or Mitchells wearing, the green and gold of Kerry, and Laune Rangers wearing the blue and white of Munster, as they turn around here to face the crowd. You can hear the crowd roaring behind us here. Very, very happy indeed. Looking forward to a marvellous game. A little bit behind schedule now. We make it 10-4 on Sunday, September 24th, 1988. As the team's being led down here by their captains, Peter Lyons, John Joe Sheehy. Behind them come their backs and their midfielders and their forwards. And as you can hear, the atmosphere here is only Rangers, the mascots are out over on the sideline, and they marching away. They're clapping on the sideline here for some of the great supporters, some of the elderly men. It's going to make a week a month in Mitchells if they win. It could make the same at Killarney. The betting, I said earlier, was even Stevens earlier on before Martin Dennehy and Anthony Gleeson became injured. Then the bookies were quoting 5-6 to Mitchells, 4-7 Laune Rangers. The betting has gone everywhere. A lot of money taken by a one bookmaker in Tralee, Colin McLaughlin, as we see the three mascots there marching out the field, taking on Mitchells at the beginning of the year. And now the teams are going into position as the pipe band makes its way off to the far side of the field, and any moment now this historic county final will be taking place. Now ready for this game as referee Dan Minehan for today's final from Killarney Legion. Dan started refereeing in East Kerry in 1984, has refereed games at all levels including minor under 21 and junior county final. This man puts a lot of emphasis on physical fitness, and it is a very big occasion for him as both sets of players now out there in the middle of the field ready for the throw-in. They are Joe Shannon, James O'Shea, James O'Dowd and Anthony Gleeson. Referee looking at his watch, checking with his linesman, Dan O'Sullivan over on the far side here, linesman on this side. And the stage is set now for the 1989 Senior County Championship Final on shot at Bork MacDonald. Eagle Orna, rhetoric faking the Urador, as I say in my maiden age, picking Clehisha, or Hussnu again. The tension, you can feel it creeping up the side of our scaffolding. The crowd are huddled in on the far side in the stand. Many people feel it's going to be a really tremendous game. The ball is in and the game is on. It's broken down, and first to break away are Laune Rangers in the forum of Joe Shannon. And Joe Shannon driving along, attacking, probing ball. Remember, Laune Rangers playing with the win in his first half. In towards number 15, Billy O'Sullivan, the danger man. 18-year-old Billy O'Sullivan passing it back to number 13, Paul Griffin. And Paul Griffin's kick, the wind, you can see how strong it is. Oh, a dangerous probing ball with Roddy Kilgannon coming forward and driving a high relieving clearance out towards the far sideline. And again, away comes Joe Shannon. Pass gone too high, out over the inline and gone harmlessly wide. Out comes Roddy Kilgannon now, the breeze with blowing into his face as Roddy drives a good long ball out, finding out in the middle of the field, young Ogie Sheehy wearing number 5 on his back. And Mitchell's coming on the attack again now in the middle of the field out towards young Anthony Gleeson. But Joe Shannon coming and pulling on the ball. A marvellous drive from Joe Shannon. Oh, a marvellous drive into the hands of Roddy Kilgannon. That's telling you how strong the wind is. Roddy Kilgannon out to his number 7, Robert O'Dowd. And Robert O'Dowd finding Jim O'Donnell. And Jim O'Donnell driving a good throwing ball, but well held by the Killarney number 6 as Mitchell's burst away. Caught, well held there by Tommy Johnson. But a marvellous clearance out there by the Mitchell's number 4, Jim O'Donnell. The wind is blowing, as I said, very, very strong, blowing down the field and favouring in a very, very big way John Mitchell. But as we have seen before in games down the years, the wind often makes no difference whatsoever. That was proven in the game before this. Well, we'll have to wait and see as we tick into the first 2 minutes of this game gone. The kick is good. A marvellous drive right down the middle by young Mac O'Connor. Mac O'Connor's fetch, well held in there by the one of the Mitchell's defenders. Looks to be Jim O'Donnell again. This man really in the thick of it, Jim O'Donnell, 27 years of age, working with the ESB in Tralee. He's a twin brother of the number 3, Frank O'Donnell. Both are 27 years of age, and they're twin brothers, and very, very friendly couple indeed. Down to magic, magical Donald McAvoy, as he's known in the Mitchell's club, turning onto his right foot and trying to find the injured Martin Dennehy. Larry is pushing the back by the Laune Rangers full-back, Paddy Sheehan, and referee says, you cannot do that, thou shalt not push in the back, because in the Gaelic rules, it is a free kick, and Martin Dennehy, who's wearing his left leg, is very heavily bandaged because he is suffering from a hamstring injury, and time alone will tell whether he'll stick out the full 60 minutes of this game. The kick from Martin is floating into the wind. It's breaking down in there, but well fetched in there by Timmy Fleming, who's back in defence. Timmy's flick is out over the inline, and it's a 50 ball for John Mitchells. This will be taken out here. It looks to be Robert O'Dowd. We're not sure where he's standing back with his number. It looks to be Robert O'Dowd. Yes, indeed it is. And Robert O'Dowd, the 24-year-old man who works in Kerry Fashions in Tralee, standing back, coming up on his right leg. And Robert's drive is not rising too high. But a dangerous ball. It's twisted in over the bar. A marvellous score, really. Coming in from nowhere by the captain of the team. Coming in there and leading his team in style by getting the first score for John Mitchells after exactly 3 minutes and 40 seconds. Yes, indeed. John Joe Sheehy, the financial consultant with the UDT in Tralee, coming in there from a kick which didn't seem to rise high enough by Robert Dowd, but John Joe came to the end of it and fisted it over the bar, and the Mitchells lead. Coolie Noirlog has gone in, scored fight of force. And Laune Rangers, the crowd, you can hear them, the Mitchell supporters getting behind their team. Laune Rangers supporters getting behind their team in the very, very early stages of this game in marvellous, brilliant sunshine here in Killarney on this Sunday, September 24th, 1989. A kick out towards the far sideline by a Laune Rangers player going to hop over the far sideline. Yes, indeed it is. Sideline ball. John Mitchell to be taken again by Robert Dowd. Robert Dowd, who's winner already of a senior of another 21 county championship with Whit Mitchells going back a number of years ago. He also has won senior town championship and league medals in the town of Tralee. Back stands Robert now, getting the foot into the ball. A good drive this time from Robert. Remember, Robert is playing into the wind as Laune Rangers burst forward again in the form of Joe Shannon. And Joe Shannon onto his right foot now. Joe's kick looks like it's going out for the sideline. Gone out over the sideline. Sideline ball for John Mitchells to be taken, I'm sure, more than likely by Jim O'Donnell. Jim O'Donnell, yes. Frank handing it over to Jim. Frank is wearing the hair a little bit long, and Jim is wearing it a little bit short. Two very, very popular players, these O'Donnell brothers, in the Mitchells Club in Tralee. A good drive now, a very, very good drive into the middle of the field. It's caught out there and well held again by the captain, John Joe. John Joe Sheehy, captaining the team in 89. John Higgins is brought to the ground. And if you see a little spot on the bottom of your screen, well, it's the sun. Every time the sun comes out, it glares into our camera. But John Higgins, or as he's known in the Mitchells Club, Gunter, 26 years of age, holder of 3 All-Ireland medals, 1 National League medal, a Munster under 21 medal, and a Kerry Championship under 21 medal. Back he stands. The drive from John is down towards Magic, but Magic is beaten down by young Mac O'Connor, who incidentally is hit on the shoulder, hit on the side of the head. This will be a free to Laune Rangers. In comes number 15 for Laune Rangers, John Roach, and surely his name will go in the book. No need for that referee. Dan Bond coming in now, as Mac O'Connor got a nasty little cloud on the side of the head. Mac O'Connor, as I said earlier, as I'm going to say now, is 20 years of age. He's a first cousin actually of the other wing back, and he's a grandson of Chubb O'Connor. Yes, indeed, referee putting the note of John Roach into his little blue book. Normally it's a black book, but today Dan Mining has got a blue book. This kick to be taken by the cornerback. The crowd, you can hear them booing him, and not really the great thing to do, but the kick is good this time. The kick is good from James Sheehan. Down again, but the man coming forward is John Higgins, and John Higgins bursting forward. Foul by Timmy Fleming. John didn't like one bit of that, and he says, Timmy, don't do that again. But Timmy says, I was playing the ball, John. As referee says, put it down on Robert Dowd. The man with a tight haircut looks a bit like a film star, standing back now, clad in the green and gold of Kerry, and 24-year-old Robert driving. Robert, kick is good, high into the middle of the sky, going to break down. No, it's well held in there by 27-year-old Joe Shannon, and Joe leaves it there for a free kick to be taken by Timmy Fleming. Timmy Fleming saying, leave it to Mac O'Connor. Mac O'Connor is saying, yes, talking Misha A. And Mac O'Connor, as I said, 20 years of age. He's a student. He was the captain of the 87 minor team that won the championship. He has 2 senior county league medals, 2 minor county league medals, and 2 senior mid-Kerry championship medals. Back he stands now. Mac's kick is good. The wind is dying slightly at this moment in time. Running onto this ball here is number 9 for Killarney, and the kick from him is going out to the right and gone harmlessly wide. The kick from James O'Shea, there he is coming out, 20-year-old James O'Shea, gone out to the right and gone harmlessly wide after 7 minutes and 38 seconds of play. The scoreboard reads John Mitchells, Coolie na Mhaoin, Killarney, no score. There's a bit of wide angle play from time to time. Kick out from Rory Kilgannon, coming into the middle of the field with the wind blowing into his face. Up goes an untimed fetch by the Killarney number 11. However, Timmy Fleming gets it into the number 13, Paul Griffin. And Paul Griffin's kick looks to be good. Yes, indeed, Paul Griffin's kick is very good. After 8 minutes and 41 seconds of play, there you can see the scoreboard. It reads now, Coolie na Mhaoin for Laune Rangers of Killarney, August Coolie na Mhaoin for the Mish Daily of Tralee. You can see the crowd now really huddled in together. A very, very big crowd up there on the far side. Out comes Rory Kilgannon again. Rory's kick is good into the middle of the field from Rory. Up, the hands go for it. Well fetched out there by Joe Shannon. And Joe Shannon busting forward. Nothing casual about that. Driving forward. putting Jonathan Murphy on the attack in towards young Billy O'Sullivan, and Billy O'Sullivan being pulled, Billy O'Sullivan being fouled, and referee says a free into Killarney for a foul by Frank O'Donnell. Free kick to be taken by Timmy Fleming. 9 minutes, almost 10 gone. Up comes Timmy. Timmy's kick, would you believe it, has gone to the left and gone harmlessly wide. Oh my, a bad miss there for Killarney. Oh yes indeed, a very, 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 could be a very costly miss for Laune Rangers, as a kick off Rory Kilgannon, marvelly fished in the middle of the field by James O'Dowd. James O'Dowd down the middle, now him coming for that magical Donald McAvoy, and Donald McAvoy turning onto his left foot, turning onto his right foot, kicking it in towards the half forward line. The ball is going to break down, and the other man coming off for a young John Roach, who works for the AIB in Dublin, Grafton Street, replacing the corner forward of last week, Johnny Keller, across to the captain, John Joe Sheehy, and John Joe Sheehy is brought to the ground. No, referee says John Joe overplayed the ball, and he's awarding a free out to Laune Rangers to be taken by their number four, James Sheehan. And James Sheehan, in actual fact, is 29 years of age. He's a building contractor, and he coached the team that won the 1987 County Minor Championship, Killarney. And that team, of course, playing that time with Timmy Fleming, Paul Griffin, Mark O'Connor, Billy O'Sullivan, Paddy Casey and Paddy McKenna. So he trained that team and has many of those players on this side today. As away comes Jonathan Murphy, a great minor, with a very bad accident at underage level. The ball broken down this time by Frank O'Donnell, and Frank O'Donnell bursting forward onto his right foot. A marvellous drive by Frank O'Donnell, way out in the middle of the field. One-handed effort there of a fetch, but a pull on the Laune Rangers player, by a Mitchell's player, and this free kick to be taken out in the middle of the field, right over on the far side, to be taken by Shane O'Sullivan. Shane O'Sullivan, who is 21 years of age, and as I said earlier, he's a first cousin of the other wing-back, Mark O'Connor, and he also is a grandson of the famous Chubb O'Connor. He was captain of the minor team that won the 1986 County League. A good drive from Shane O'Sullivan down the middle, but who does he find but number 5, Ogie Sheehy. And Ogie Sheehy driving well down the field into the corner forward, Johnny Roach driving a dangerous ball in towards Martin Dinhey, and Martin Dinhey going for the ball. 23-year-old Carpenter turning onto his left foot. Is he going to try and float one across? He's going onto his right foot. He's being pulled. Referee says play on. He passes the ball back out to Donald McAvoy. Donald McAvoy going nowhere. Back out again towards the full forward line now, breaking about him there. But away, burst caught Laune Rangers in the form of Anthony Shannon. Anthony Shannon trying to find his brother Joe. And Joe grabbing it nicely now, turning onto his right foot. And Joe driving the ball down. But who does he find? Only John Higgins. A lot of nerves, a lot of anxious moments in this early moments of the first half. 13 minutes gone. Both sets of players. And John Higgins drives a marvellous kick. Oh, it looks to be going out to the right. Yes, indeed it is. Out to the right and gone harmlessly wide. Back goes Peter Lyons, the PRO, the captain of this team, to kick out this ball. Peter standing back now. Peter's drive going out into the middle of the field. Up go the hands for it. Well held out there again by John Higgins. John Higgins driving it down this side of the field now, trying to find the corner forward. But the man going back for it is Joe Shannon, leaving it to the full back. And that man is Paddy Sheehan. Paddy Sheehan's kick is locked down, gone towards the sideline. The linesman is putting up the flag. It's a Mitchell's ball over on the far side. And the crowd can tell you that from the roar from Mitchell's. The linesman raises his flag over on the far side. And Martin Dennehy, the man coming over to take it now. Martin, who's a qualified carpenter, a great stalwart for the Mitchell's team. He's in on the 21 Munster Championship medal with Kerry. Another 21 County Championship medal. The kick is low across the verge of the goal. Lost by Shane O'Sullivan into the hands of the man bursting forward, James Sheehan. And James Sheehan, a man that leads by example, driving out the forward. The man who is really cleaning up a lot of ball here is John Higgins. And John Higgins, who works for the ESB in Tralee, former Kerry senior player. Maybe he'll make it again this year, driving it down to the middle. And the ball is grabbed in there, and majestically grabbed in there by a man who's playing back deep in defence. That's the 20-year-old Timmy Fleming, finding Jordan Murphy, 23 years of age. Jordan Murphy being pulled. Referee Dan Mynans in advantage. Play on. Jordan doing it nicely. Jordan being tripped, losing the ball, but giving it back over on the far side to Shane O'Sullivan. The kick from Shane is good. Right down the middle, down towards the number 9. But the man grabbing it back there again. His man is that marvellous footballer, Frank O'Donnell. And Frank finding his Drahar. Back kick Frank again. And Frank back to number 7, Robert Dowd. Mitchell's playing good stuff in this early stages of the first half. Down the middle towards number 8, Robert Dowd. Our number 8, Gomeleshkale, James O'Dowd. And James O'Dowd's kick is locked down here in the middle of the field. It's a sideline ball. This one will be taken by Donald McAvoy. Donald McAvoy, 22 years of age, works in Tittleton in Tralee. 2 months under 21 championship medals. He also has 2 hurling championship medals. And he has played minor, senior in under 21 for Kerry. The drive is good from Donald McAvoy into this brilliant sunshine here now, as busting forward now for Killarney is Pierce Pendleville. And Pierce Pendleville's drive going out towards the far side and over. He's being chased, he's being harried. It's gone over the sideline with a sideline ball for John Mitchell right across on the far side. This to be taken by Gunter Higgins, John Higgins wearing number 6, hoping, he told me earlier, to get back in the Kerry team this year. But he said his pride and joy, he said, would be in his lifetime would be to win a senior county championship medal for his beloved Mitchells. Of John Joe Sheehy Road in Tralee, up comes John. John's drive is good, right down the middle. But again, this finding Shane O'Sullivan, who in turn finds Pierce Prindeville. And Pierce Prindeville's kick is poorly again into a Mitchell's player again. And it's all, that's Kieran Minan, young Kieran Minan. We're down to young Donald McAvoy. Donald McAvoy now covering a lot of ground. He's fisting it down to James O'Dowd. James O'Dowd down to Jim O'Donnell. And Jim O'Donnell driving forward, going to have a pat for a pint. Jim's kick is going too far to the left. Jim's kick is going to be kept in play. It's not out to the left, and it's gone harmlessly wide. Our time gone in the game, 60 minutes and 17 seconds as the scoreboard reads. 1 point for Killarney, 1 point for the Mitchells. As the PRO of the Killarney club, the captain of the Killarney club, the man who was born in England, comes out to take this kick out. The last time Killarney and Laune Rangers played in the Championship, and Mitchells played, was back in 83, and on that particular occasion Peter Lyons was playing at wing forward. The kick from Peter is good, but again, following the captain, John Joe will have a pot. John Joe's kick is high. John Joe's kick is looking good. Is it gone over? Yes, indeed. The crowd tells its own story, and Mitchells lead again. 2 points to one after exactly 17 minutes of the first half. Oh, John Joe coolly, calmly looked up, picked his spot, and slotted it safely and cleanly between the posts. Peter Lyons coming out now with the cap on his head, because the sun is very, very strong at times. It comes out and blowing directly, or should I say, shining directly into the eyes of the Killarney backs when it does come out. The kick this time is good from Peter against the wind. Up they go, grabbing for it. The man who's going for it now is Johnny Roach. The ball is bobbing in the ground. The man grabbing it is number 10, but referee said, Kieran Keller, 20-year-old Kieran Keller, you have fouled. And he awards the free kick to Killarney to be taken by Mark O'Connor. Mark O'Connor, who played a marvellous game. I saw him playing in a game against St. Kieran's, and on that occasion he was marking young Pad and Ethan Curra, and he struck me as being a very, very tight marker indeed, and a great man to judge a ball, a great man to tackle, and plays very, very fairly and cleanly at all times. Up comes Mark. The kick to Mark is low, a poor kick, but it finds Timmy Fleming, and Timmy's drive now trying to find Billy Sullivan. They're pumping those balls into him, but Billy again being pushed in the back. Referee says it's a free in to Laune Rangers, and this man, Billy Sullivan, number 15, taking his place now in there in the full forward line. What a great year it has been for him. 1989, he was the minor captain this year of both Kerry and Laune Rangers. He saved a great goal in the 88 final, as this free kick now to be taken by Timmy Fleming. It doesn't really suit a right-legged kicker, and it is indeed a pity they haven't got. Well, up comes Timmy. Timmy tries to cuddle it nicely, and Timmy cuddles it beautifully. Out he comes there, Timmy Fleming, 20 years of age, former Kerry minor, Kerry on the 21 star, and now Kerry senior footballer, 22 years of age. A Gumalish Gael, 20 years of age, and he's farming back in his native Killarney as Rory Kilgannon comes out. I said earlier about Rory. Well, Rory has done marvellous work with the club in Mitchells, both at underage, at minor level, always involved in club activities. He's at present the club secretary. He is a mechanical engineer with Tillotson in Tralee. Out he comes now. The kick from Rory is good. Out to the middle again. The kicks don't seem to be rising that high today, as John Higgins grabbed it nicely, and he is brought to the ground in turn by young Gero de Morocco. This kick to be taken by Ogie Sheehy. Robert O'Dowd, Gumalish Gael Ogie. Robert O'Dowd, with the man who's grabbing the ball this time, is Joe Shannon to Jared Murphy. Jared Murphy driving a good long probing ball. There could be a score on here if it flicks ahead. There's a man gone right through here, and he's gone right. Must be a goal. A great save by Rory Kilgannon. Oh my, gone right through there was James O'Shea. And Rory Kilgannon put the hands across and proved that that's going to be a vital save yet after 19 minutes and 50 seconds. A man gone right through, James O'Shea, looked to have the goal at his mercy, but Rory Kilgannon, the man we were just speaking of, spanned himself across, the kick, and said that away come Killarney again. Gerald Murphy now bursting forward, but the Mitchells players are playing with great heart, playing, the fence are playing well. Gerald Murphy's drive gone out to the right and gone harmlessly wide, and the crowd cheering that one. But it was a score of great, a golden chance gone a begging there for Laune Rangers. Oh my, oh my. Laune Rangers played a game here on this pitch about a week ago against the Duhalla Seniors. John Mitchells were over here on Friday night for the kick around. So both sides have got the feel of the pitch. but they haven't got the feel of it with such a big crowd. Out comes Rory Kilgannon again. Exactly 20 and a half minutes gone in this, the first half. And again, Killarney bursting forward now in the form of Jerry Murphy. He will surely score here onto his right foot. And would you believe it? Gone out to the right and gone harnessy wide again. And the scoreboard reads 2 points for Killarney, 2 points for Mitchells. Out comes the hero so far, Rory Kilgannon, out to the middle of the field. Anthony Gleeson going up marvellously. Anthony not fetching. The man who's grabbing it is James O'Shea. The ball driven in towards Billy Sullivan again. Billy pushed on the back again. The referee says another free for a push by Frank O'Donnell. Frank O'Donnell doesn't like one bit of that. Frank O'Donnell, of course, already has another 21 championship medal, one with Mitchells, and would dearly love to win here. He also has two ESP All-Ireland Interferum medals. And he walks with his brother Frank, as I said, or his brother Jim, already in the ESP. Backstands Timmy Fleming, hoping to make it 3-2. The time gone, 21 minutes 40 seconds. Up comes Timmy Fleming. The drive from Timmy is good. Is it good enough? Gone out to the left, and my oh my, Laune Rangers are missing, really and truly, missing an amount of chances in these attacks they're having in the first half. They might dearly rue those before this game is over, because they really have been attacking now in droves for the last 10 minutes, but having nothing to show for. The scoreboard still reads 2 points apiece, and the time gone in the game, 22 minutes exactly. Out comes Rory Kilgannon again. The drive from Rory is good, but the fetch is majestic out in the middle of the field there by Anthony Gleeson. A marvellous catch playing Donald McAvoy. The crowd, when Donald moves, they rise to him onto his right foot. 1966, the last won a county title. The drive from Donald, he's trying to find the corner forward. That he does. And the number 13 is bursting forward. Nolly Kelleher. Nolly Kelleher still going. Nolly Kelleher's a pot. A dangerous ball. Blocked the ball in there. Out comes the Killarney fullback. Referee going in, Dan Mining, what's he going to say? Yes, he's awarding a free out there, well held by Paddy Sheehan. A quick probing ball from Nolly Keller, a small, low-sized man. He's low to the ground, he's lightning fast. Killarney avert the danger, and a free out to be taken by Peter Lyons. Peter has two All-Ireland vocational medals as well, of course, and his uncle Tony actually played in goals on the Mid-Kerry team that won the 1967 County Championship. Out comes the ball to the middle of the field. Gone to Higgins going for it, leaving it to Robert Dowd, and Robert Dowd loses the ball, and away come Killarney again in the forum of Jared Murphy in between his legs. John Higgins going back, but the man who's bursting forward now is Joe Shannon. Back to Jared Murphy, left legged drive from Jared. It looks to be good. It's gone straight and through. It's gone over the bar, and the lead again for Killarney, 3 points to 2. The man who scored it, Jared Murphy, and what a marvellous footballer he was in the very early days. He's 23 years of age. He walks with King in Killarney. He got a very bad knee injury in 1984, just before the Munster Minor Final. He's the holder of an under-21 Munster Minor Championship, or under-21 Munster under-21 Championship medal, the same year they were beaten by Donegal in that final. And he has 2 Senior County League medals and 3 Mid-Kerry Championships. So that's a fair roll of honour, as Rory Kilgannon once again makes his way out to the middle of the field to kick out to the 21-yard line to kick this one. After that, very, very good score by Killarney. 3 points to 2. Remember, Mitchells are playing with a strong wind. Killarney are playing against it, and they lead by a point. Well hit and well fetched by young Anthony Gleeson. Back to number 5, Ogie Sheehy. Ogie Sheehy's drive down the middle, finding John Roach. And John Roach driving forward now onto his right foot. He'll have a pot. John Roach's kick is good into Peter Lyons. Well held by Peter Lyons. And Peter's kick finding his full back. Paddy Sheehan, 27-year-old farmer from Killarney, the quiet man of the team, the coolest man under pressure that helped me. Paddy bursting forward, and Paddy's drive now coming down towards Paul Griffin, down towards Paul Griffin in number 4, Jim O'Donnell. But referee says a push by Paul and Jim O'Donnell, and this free kick to be taken by Jim himself. Jim himself standing back now, right outside the sideline, down underneath our camera position here. There you can see the ball below. Up comes Jim. Jim's drive is good. Into the middle again, grabbed and broken down into the hands of Donald McAvoy. Magical McAvoy, can he do magic here? I'm afraid not. And out to the left, and it's gone harmlessly wide again. So out comes Peter Lyons again, and as I was saying earlier, his uncle played in 67 County Final. His grandfather, Denny O, played in the 1909 and 1910 Final, as we're having a bit of action down here to the far side. Referee making his way down to have a chat with his umpire. Something must have happened off the ball, as I was telling you there, and he's now coming out to have a little word with somebody down there in the back line. It looks to be the number two Mitchell's player, Kieran Minan, the youngest player Mitchell's have on the field, and that's not Kieran's style, but he's having a chat with Kieran. Something must have happened between Kieran. Gomalesh Gale, yes, Kieran Minan, yes. And the Laune Rangers number 15, Billy O'Sullivan, not sure what happened, but the play goes on. Out comes Peter Lyons again after that booking up on the far side. I was telling you, his uncle, his grandfather, Denny O, played in the 1909 and 1910 final versus Mitchells. And his granduncle, John Joe Falvey, won the Munster Meidner Medal in 1934 as we get on with the game. And this time the ball going down towards the sideline, out over the sideline by James Sheehan. There we see the sideline man, that man there, Dan Bonn O'Sullivan, Kerry minus Lector this year, Kerry minus Lector last year when they won the All-Ireland title, as Jim O'Donnell coming down again. Jim keeping himself quite busy now today. One wonders, will Jim be reporting for work tomorrow with the ESB if Mitchells bring off this title, their first it will be since 1966. Could we have a draw? Nobody knows, but time alone will tell. The ball breaking up in the middle of the field there and grabbed out there by Dick Mitchell's number 8. James O'Dowd playing him on the attack, but out comes Anthony Shannon. And Anthony Shannon, 28 years of age, a man who has his own draper shop in Killarney. Out to Anthony, another Anthony Gleeson. Anthony Gleeson's kick has gone out to the right and gone harmlessly wide up there on your screen. You can see the stopwatch. It says gone in the game exactly 27 minutes and 45 seconds. The time is now ticking and ticking into the end of this first half. The scoreboard is 3 points, it says, for Laune Rangers, 2 points, it says, for Mitchells. It's a low scoring first half, but I'm sure that won't worry either club if they will pull off this here today. A good drive out of the middle of the field. The ball is broken down out there. Referee says a foul on one of the players out there, and he's awarding a free to Killarney. Well, both teams have done a lot of training, have done a lot of hard work to get to this county final day today, and indeed I suppose it's a tribute to Nola Mahoney of Killarney, their trainer John Clifford and Patsy Joy. Nola Mahoney, of course, was a national teacher, took over charge of this team way back in 1983, and since then it's been success and success as Laune Rangers pump forward now again in the forum of Joe Shannon, overplaying the ball. Referee says play on, a push in the back, referee says play on again, back out to Gerard Murphy. Gerard Murphy turning on to his right foot. Gerard Murphy's kick again, would you believe it, gone out to the right and gone harmlessly wide. But as I was speaking there about the trainer of the Laune Rangers team, well, that man Nola Mahoney, and the trainer of course of the John Mitchell's team, is a very, very well known face of course, and has been in charge of their team for quite some time also, and he is ably assisted by a number of very, very good selectors indeed. The name of their trainer of course is Teddy O'Dowd, is a selector. Dennis Fitzgerald is the trainer, and Johnny Keller is the selector. The ball drives forward again right down the middle here, but again it's caught by a Laune Rangers player, that man bursting forward. Referee says play on, bursting forward and playing very well in there, James Sheehan. Back to Timmy Fleming, who's brought to the ground, and referee says play on, and now he awards a free to Mitchell, would you believe it. But he's the man in charge, Martin Dinney, comes out to Timmy Fleming and says look, let's get on with the game. This game is getting very, very exciting indeed. The time gone in the game. Less referee moving the ball in. The time gone in the game. Almost 29 minutes and 50 seconds. If Mitchell scored this, the sides will go in level at half-time. Back stands Martin Dennehy now getting the goals on his side. This is to bring his side level with Laune Rangers. Remember, Mitchell's playing with the aid of a very, very strong wind indeed. And the crowd here huddled in behind us wondering, can Martin do it? Up he comes, the kick for Martin is not good. It's broken down in there, and away comes Timmy Fleming again, back in that goal and saving the danger. This man is playing all over the field. Out comes the ball, Gomez Gale, that was not Timmy Fleming, that was Paddy Sheehan. A marvellous fetch by Paddy, out over the sideline here, and a sideline ball as we tick into 13 and a half minutes for John Mitchell's to be taken by Jim O'Donnell. The kick from Jim into the middle with the wind behind him, but caught this time by Ogie Sheehy. Ogie Sheehy driving it into the number 10. It's a dangerous looking ball. Gone out to the right and gone harmlessly wide, but a very, very good effort there by Kieran Kelleher from a good pass by Ogie Sheehy. And surely now referee Dan Minehan, having played 31 minutes in the first half, will blow the half-time whistle when he kicks out this ball. Peter Lyons now standing back. Down behind him on his right we see the team trainer for Laune Rangers, Nola Mahoney, getting ready to go into the dressing room, all set to go. The kick from Peter this time, will it be long? Will referee signal the whistle? He doesn't, he says play on. The wind getting stronger and stronger here. Will be aiding Mitchell's long range in the second half. Bursting forward now is Donald McAvoy. Donald McAvoy seems to be fouled. Referee says play on as Joe Shannon drives a good relieving ball down towards his midfield partner, 20-year-old James O'Shea, and putting in towards Billy Sullivan in front of goal. A goal here would be a great tonic. Billy Sullivan shoots low. It's a goal for Laune Rangers, coming after exactly 31 minutes and 50 seconds of the first half. Oh, a marvellous goal from the man who scored a goal against Stacks, which brought him into the county final. And referee blows a full-time whistle after exactly 32 minutes of the first half. Oh, that goal was a vital tonic. Billy Sullivan turning nicely. He is a danger man. He's only 18 years of age, but what a goal as the sides now make their way in at half-time. No, Laune Rangers,
it's an important goal.
I'm sure we'll be very happy. The Mitchells players won't be at all happy with that when they see in particular that the referee played 2 minutes of injury time. They're now heading into the dressing room at half time. The scoreboard reading 1-3 to 2 points, but there they head in. I'm sure their trainer will have a lot of words to say to their defence for the lax marking, and particularly their ability with Juddle, because he is indeed a dangerous man to mark, a very hard man to mark. The Laune Rangers players will be disappointed with all the chances they have missed, and still they lead by 4 points, having missed some marvellous scores. But Mitchells never give up, and they are known to have a marvellous fighting spirit. They don't look to be too happy going into the half-time. They will see their chairman, Buddy O'Grady. But it is indeed now the scene is set for what's going to be hopefully a marvellous second half. So, up there we see the Mitchell supporters waving their banners high in the sky. Up to John Mitchell, their side are trailing by 1-3 to 2 points at half-time. And up there behind them you can see quite a large crowd huddled in together. There's another Mitchell's banner behind. And down to the right we can see all the young lads clad in the green and gold jerseys. Right down along there, yes, a marvellous crowd over here on this far side. Many people felt, well, we wouldn't have a very big crowd on this side, but there is indeed a very, very large crowd right down along the whole way to the right-hand side. And up below on the tree we can see people getting very, very advantageous positions. There you can see quite a good crowd huddled in together there. There we have the scoreboard. Reading 1-3 for Laune Rangers, 2 points for the Mitchell League. We'll be back with you in just a moment for the second half. So yes, here we are back live for the start of the second half, and both sets of players really clad in new rig outs, of course. Allardyce Banks, of course, kindly sponsored both teams with jerseys, togs, socks, the lot, you name it, as indeed they have sponsored this county championship as well. Referee Dan Miney now getting ready, what's going to be, what could be a very, very tense second half. The scoring is tight, it just says exactly 4 points between the sides. The wind is now favouring Laune Rangers. This now is when the Mitchell's metal and spirit will be really tested. The ball is in, and the second half is on, and first to break away are Laune Rangers in the form of Joe Shannon, but referee says he's awarding a free to Mitchell for a push on one of the of their players. This will be taken, I'm sure, by John Higgins. Yes, indeed, John Higgins will take this one. Ogie Sheehy making a quick run. Will John pass it? No. John says, Gunter says no. Take it easy, Ogie. Ogie Sheehy, of course, will be immigrating to America on Thursday next, or to England rather, to take up a job with British Airways. Meanwhile, there's a push in the back in here, and referee awards a free end to John Mitchell. There's a mistake to be taken, I'm sure, by Martin Dinehy. Martin Dinehy, the 23-year-old carpenter, whom they call in the club Larry, or Loros, after Larry Tompkins, because he's their top scorer so far in this year's championship. He takes it quickly and passes it back to the captain, John Joe Sheehy, and Mitchells have scored the first score of the second half after exactly 1 minute and 6 seconds of play. And the man who scores it, John Joe Sheehy, the man who hopes to emulate his two previous Sheehys by taking the cup home to John Joe Sheehy Road tonight. And that's what the road for Mitchells Club and Tralee is based on is actually called. Out comes Peter Lyons. The sun is growing strong into our camera here now on the far side. The ball caught by Anthony Gleeson, whose shoulder I'm sure is not at all right. But again, Laune Rangers, Gerard Murphy on the attack now. Gerard, who works with Kling Pharmaceutical Company in Killarney, in towards the goal hero, Billy O'Sullivan, back to the full forward, wearing number 15. Patty McKenna, and Patty McKenna back over towards Gerard Murphy again. Back to Joe Shannon. Joe Shannon's drive, or James O'Shea's driving the dangerous ball out to the right for a 50. Yes, a 50 ball. So Timmy Fleming now standing back to take this 50. This could be a score. The wind is behind him, straight in front of goal. Surely it will be a score. Timmy's drive is poorly out to the right, and again gone harmlessly wide. Oh my, oh my. Those are chances one cannot afford to miss in a senior county championship final. Rory Kilgannon now standing back and coming out again about a drive, and Rory's kick is good. Out finding a Mitchell's man over on the far side. That man at the moment is Donald McAvoy. Donald McAvoy brought to the ground by Pierce Prendeville, and Donald McAvoy pushes back Pierce Prendeville, and the crowd don't like that, so referee may well go over and off the ball. Time alone will tell. No, he's allowing the free in the free right over on the far side to be taken by Robert Dowd. The kick is good now, right into the middle again, putting Mitchells on the attack. Mitchells are a team who have been known never to die hard. Laune Rangers, the team who have had massive underage success. Mitchells bursting forward now again, as the ball is broken out of the middle of the field here. Away comes Johnny Roach, and Johnny Roach now on his right foot, bursting forward, trying to find Anthony Gleeson. Anthony Gleeson brought to the ground, referee says play on, and Anthony driving forward now with a nice solo onto his right foot out to Ogie Sheehy. Ogie Sheehy's drive now is blocked down, but again comes Johnny Roach, and Johnny Roach now turning onto his right foot, being well harassed in there by Timmy Fleming. He falls to the ground, throws the ball back to Martin Dennehy, and Martin Dennehy driving forward. Referee says it's a free end for John Mitchells. I'm not sure, but it looks like there is a Mitchell's number 16 on the field, and it looks like a number 16 wearing a bandage on his leg. We'll tell you that in a moment. This free kick quickly taken by Martin Dennehy, right across to this number 16 sub, who we'll tell in a moment who he is. Back to Martin Dennehy again. Martin Dennehy will have a left leg drive here. Well, he's right in front of goal. He'll surely score here. Back out again to Noli Keller. Noli Keller, drive is good. Straight and through and over the bar. A marvellous drive from Noli Keller, the 29 years of age, walks in Goblin and Tralee, and a former boxing champion. A marvellous drive. Nice dilly-dally play there. But the man who looks to be on is number 16, John Hegarty indeed. The man who did not make it for today's game, from what I can gather, because of disciplinary reasons. But John Hegarty playing very well, involved in the making of that point in there. And indeed, John Hegarty, he's 27 years of age. He has represented Kerry Juniors, and would you believe it, he has a senior London championship medal. The kick out of the middle of the field this time is good. It's high, it's broken down again. The man who's grabbing it is young Shane O'Sullivan. Back to Timmy Fleming. Timmy Fleming onto his right foot. His kick half blocked down. The scoreboard reads 1-3 to 4 points. Galloglin on the attack again. This man this time grabbing the ball again is Shane O'Sullivan. And Shane O'Sullivan, who works with Lee Strand in Tralee, in towards the full forward. Billy Sullivan turning onto his left foot. He has a pot. The kick from Billy, it's gone away out to the left. It looks like it's going to go wide. And yes, indeed, it's gone away out to the left and gone harmlessly wide. Out comes the drive from Rory Kilgannon, out towards the middle of the field for now. John Joshi has come to midfield. John Higgins out there as well. And the ball is well held by Gunter Higgins on the ground to Gerard Murphy. And Gerard Murphy sees the space. Is he going to have a pot for a point? Yes, indeed he is. The pot looks to be good. The pot is great. The pot is through. Gone over the bar. After 7 minutes of play, Laune Rangers lead 1-4 to 4 points as Gerard Murphy comes out there. He works with the King Pharmaceutical Company in Killarney. And yes, indeed, there is no truth in the rumour that they make anabolic steroids. No, that is not. That is false information. Quite a number of these players actually work in the Kling factory in Killarney. Also, Pierce Prendeville, of course, who plays at centre half hour, works there also. The kick out from Rory Kilgannon, the 27-year-old mechanical engineer, is good. Out towards John Joe Sheehy, and John Joe Sheehy trying to lead his charges down the field, with a man coming out and pulling on the ball as a fullback. A marvellous pull by young Paddy Sheehan. And Paddy Sheehan down to Billy Sullivan. A nice flick on by Billy Sullivan. On towards number 9, James Sheehan, into Paul Griffin. And Paul Griffin cutting inside nicely. He's going straight through. Referee doesn't allow advantage. He awards a free and to Killarney for a foul by Jim O'Donnell on the in-running Paul Griffin.
Fleming now standing back to take this free kick.
getting the goals in his sights now. Up he comes, the kick from Timmy is good, the kick from Timmy is straight and through, it's over the bar, and Killarney now lead by 1-5 to 3 points. The time in our watch says exactly 8 minutes and 7 seconds. It's 4:45 on Sunday, September 24th in 1989, a historic day here in Killarney. The last time the final was played here was way back in 1963. That's the last time two, or in 75 rather, but the last time the two club sides met was way back in 1963. The kick out is good from Rory Kilgannon. It's a low kick, but it's a good kick. Long distance, with a push in the back over there on the Mitchell's player, and it's a free kick for Laune Rangers, or for Mitchell's rather, right over on the far side. Mitchell will be needing to get a score or two now again. They trail by 4 points. Of course, there's a long way to go in this game yet. And I'll never forget a day going back a number of years ago when Mitchell's were being well beaten in another 3-1 championship game here. Beaten by 3 goals. In fact, they came back from the dead to win that game. Well, this game is wide open here yet, but Killarney are in the driving seat. The club who won their first title back 101 years ago. Paul Griffin now on the attack in towards Billy Sullivan, and Billy Sullivan turning onto his right foot. Can he win a minor and senior championship medal in the same year? He plays it back to the full forward. The full forward's kick looks to be high, looks to be straight and throw. It's a marvellous drive from Paddy McKenna, and Paddy McKenna coming across right there in the picture now. There he is, Paddy McKenna. He's 20 years of age. He's going to the RTC in Tralee. His father, Sean, was a regular on the Laune Rangers team back in the early 60s. His uncle, Patsy Joy, is the present selector on this team today. And his favourite player, well, that man, Ogie Morton. He has won one championship and league medal, and he's 2 mid-Kerry championship medals. Well, that was a marvellous point from a very awkward angle. And Frank O'Donnell gave him a little bit of space. And my, oh my, how well Patty availed of that. Patty, of course, was in the minor team in 87, which was actually coached by his cornerback, James Sheehan, who won the county championship. There's a sub coming onto the field now, I think, right across on the far side. And up to the Mitchell team, we'll tell you all about that in a moment. Bursting forward now again at Kellogg, and they're really driving it home now. Gerard Murphy brought to the ground, and a free there on Gerard, and it's a free in to Laune Rangers to be taken, I'm sure, by Timmy Fleming. The wind blowing across the field now, and definitely favouring, whatever way it's going, definitely favouring Killarney, who lead by 1-6. That's a total of 9 points. The Laune Rangers 4. The time gone in the game, 10.5 minutes. Back stands Timmy Fleming. Up he comes. Timmy Fleming's drive. It looks to be good. It's gone out to the left again, and it's gone wide. Just another chance gone a-begging for Timmy Fleming. Out comes the kick out again to the middle of the field by Martin Denny. He grabs it nicely, and Martin now knows that Mitchells need a score, and they need it badly. The sun is coming out again, and away come Mitchells in the form of Nolly Kelleher. Nolly Kelleher, the danger man, driving forward. Can they manage a goal here? A goal would be vital. Johnny Hagerty bursting forward, still going. Johnny Hagerty brought to the ground. Referee says play on, allow the advantage back to Nolly Kelleher. Nolly Kelleher's kick looks to be going right, looks to be going to the wide. Yes, indeed, it's gone wide. The scoreboard reads up there, you can see it. 1-6 for the Mish Daly, or for Lona Fanahan Lona. August Kedakulini got the Mish Daly. Time gone in the game exactly, it's 12 minutes. Peter Lyons taking it out quickly this time. Out towards his full back, Paddy Sheehan. Oh, danger in there, but Paddy Sheehan getting it across to Anthony Shannon. Nothing casual about that. Out to the middle of the field. Out over the sideline here, right down under us. It's going to be a sideline ball for Laune Rangers. 6 titles they have won so far to date. 11 the Mitchells have won. The time is ticking and ticking in this game. They're in the driving seat. The grandson of Trevor O'Connor places this ball. Young Shane O'Sullivan, who works, as I said earlier, with Lee Strand in Tralee. His favourite player, he said earlier in the week, Tommy Spillane. The kick from him is good. With the wind behind him, down towards Jim O'Donnell, down towards Anthony Gleeson. Anthony Gleeson's kick, trying to find the Mitchell's man, Martin Dinney. Martin coming up, he's been beaten this time by number 6, Tommy Johnson, 32-year-old Tommy Johnson, who's a farmer in Killarney. Back to Joe Shannon, and Joe Shannon's drive is good. Into Billy Sullivan, and Billy Sullivan grabbing it nicely, turning onto his right foot. He's going to have a pot for a point. The pot looks to be good. The pot is well grabbed in there by young Rory Kilgannon. Out to number 5, Ogie Sheehy, down towards the sideline, and Johnny Roach stepping out, but the ball is in play, being faced by Shane O'Sullivan, losing the ball, back into the hands of Ogie Sheehy. Ogie Sheehy's drive down the middle here, down towards Joe Shannon. The man who's driving it forward is Joe Shannon, into the hands of Shane O'Sullivan. Turning, being hassled by Martin Denny and the Negation referee says, being fouled. The crowd don't like one bit of that. This free kick will be taken, I'm sure, by Joe Shannon. Yes, indeed, Joe Shannon. He works in the EIB in Dingle, of course. He was under 12 goalie in the 1972 team who won the under 12 county championship. He played in the last 2 Munster finals and played in wing forward in the 1980 winning minor team. A marvellous footballer. He was midfield on the under 21 team that lost to Mayo back in 83. And the last time they played Mitchell, this man who's on the ball played at midfield also. And what a marvellous game he's playing today. It'll be very hard to pick a man of the match indeed. This time we have coming again, number 14, back to Timmy Fleming, and Timmy Fleming's kick is good. It's through and through, it's over the bar. And now Laune Rangers lead 1-7, 10 points to 4. And they look to be on the driving seat. It's looking good, but the time in the game gone. Exactly 14 minutes and 3 seconds gone. The day here in Killarney is brilliant for football. The crowd is brilliant, a massive crowd. Will go down in record, I would say, as one of the biggest crowds ever to attend the county football final. We don't know exactly what number it is, but it really is definitely over the normal big crowd of around 12,000 or thereabouts, because the stand is packed. The sideline here behind us is packed. Laune Rangers lead. Mitchell's come out again to the middle of the field, but a man grabbing it this time is number 9, James O'Shea, back to Timmy Fleming. A man completely loose, Gerard Murphy. Will he be in clink tomorrow? Up, Gerard's kick comes. Gerard's kick is good. And Laune Rangers are now driving further and further ahead. They now lead by 1-9 to 4 points. Mitchells need a score now, and they need it badly if they're to entertain any hope of taking the title back for the first time since 1966. 101 years ago, remember, ladies and gentlemen, since Laune Rangers took the title back in 1911. That's going back a long, long time ago. How dearly they would love to bring it back this evening. Well, we'll have to wait and see what's going to happen. Their club has gone through marvellous underage success down the years. They have mentors there who have walked Trojan walk. Their chairman, Jerome Conway, their secretary, their treasurers, their registrars, everybody back in that club have tremendous club spirit. Indeed, so too have Mitchell. But at the moment, Laune Rangers on the driving seat. Nicely kept in play by Billy O'Sullivan. Back into a Mitchell's player again. The ball is bobbing about there. And that man, Billy O'Sullivan, back to the full forward, right in front of goal. Must be a goal here. Yes, indeed. Patty McKenna has driven a goal home after exactly 15 minutes and 40 seconds of play. And surely now, Mitchells have a mountain to climb. That man, Pat McKenna, grabbing the ball again. The man who made it, surely, must be Billy O'Sullivan. But Paddy McKenna, the 20-year-old man who's going to RTC in Tralee, he'll not report for duty, I'm sure, tomorrow or for Tuesday or Wednesday if they win this title. Out over on the far side, I can see their trainer, Nola Mahoney, and he's in great voice at the moment. The time gone in the game, 16 minutes and 9 seconds. The scoreboard reads 2-8 for Laune Rangers, 4 points for the Mitchells, and surely now the bookies are going to be right. Colin McLaughlin, Tralee, a man who took a lot of money on Mitchells at 25-1, must be smiling now. But remember, Mitchells are a team who are never beaten until the final whistle. And here comes now John Gonta Higgins driving it down the middle again towards the attacking zone area. Well, out comes Joe Shannon onto the ground. Anthony Shannon heading back now. He's 28 years of age. He has 2 Munster minor medals. He's a minor county champion, a minor county league medal. He'll be happy if he's seen a medal. Martin Denny putting them forward. A dangerous throwing ball. Referee says play on. Out comes Anthony Shannon again. Out to young Shane O'Sullivan, back again to Anthony Shannon, out to the middle to Ogie Sheehy, and Ogie Sheehy now bursting forward trying to get a score. But again, away come Laune Rangers, and they're playing marvellous football. We have a scuffle going on in there. Let's hope now that Mitchells won't lose their cool. Peter Sullivan coming out there, the PRO, keeping them calm. Oh, that's the scuffle, will you? Scuffle out there in the France that seems to be gone again. We're going back to the PRO of the club, the captain, Peter Lyons. Can he be taking the title back past the lawn tonight for the first time since 1911? I said earlier that it was 101 years since they won the title, Gormen Eshgale, 101 years since they won their first title. Peter Lyons, the 28-year-old Gareth proprietor in Killoglan, out to Timmy Fleming, the 20-year-old farmer in Killoglan, and Timmy Fleming putting the ball on the ground. Laune Rangers looking very well in there. Their blue and white rig out is indeed a Mitchell. The man is loose here. That man is 26-year-old Pierce Pendleton, one of the greatest workers on this team. He pops up all over the field, back to Timmy Fleming, and Fleming's kick looks to be curling in. The umpire says gone out to the right and it's gone wide. Well, what the umpire says goes. The kick out from Rory Kilgannon again. He's side trailing by 2-8, which is 14 points to 4. That's a total of 10 points, and they look to be in a very, very dangerous position now. Again, Laune Rangers coming forward. Mitchell's never give up. And again, the ball is grabbed on the ground here by the great stalwart number 8. James O'Dowd, and James O'Dowd to Anthony Gleeson. Anthony Gleeson's kick down now, finding a Mitchell's man all in his own here. That man, number 16, Johnny Hegarty. And Johnny Hegarty now bursting forward, finding in towards the full forward line. Back to Johnny Hegarty again. Back to number 13, Nolly Kelleher. Oh my, a chance that was looked to be a goal written all over it. Quite a big crowd in there in front of the goal, and Nolly's kick just went slightly out to the right and went wide. Oh my, a chance gone a begging there again. But that's the way football goes. You've got to take your chances. If you don't take your chances, there's a sub coming into the field for Laune Rangers. Can't see who he is at the moment. Who's going off, I'm not sure. Yes, there's a sub into the field. We're not sure who's going off. We'll tell you that in a moment. It looks to be number 9, James Shea, is going off the Killarney team. Yes, indeed, having played quite a good game. And he has been replaced, I think, by number 16, Danny Cahill. And Danny Cahill is in the game now. A marvellous gesture by the Killarney mentors to bring him on to this stage of the game. And James Shea doesn't mind one bit as John Murphy drives forward again. Killarney now, a team who have worked hard over the years at underage. A team who have won all underage. And this will be the icing on the cake for the first time in the history since 1911. As the kick is taken in, gone to the right and gone harmlessly wide this time. Kicked again by Paddy McKenna. He will live on that goal he scored today for many, many years to come. He'll watch it, I'm sure, in slow motion. He'll watch it time after time after time. The kick out is quickly taken by Roddy Kilgannon. The time is ticking and ticking now. 20 minutes and 14 seconds left in this, the second half of the 89 County Championship Final. A push on the back there by Johnny Roach. And a free in for Killarney to be taken by Joe Shannon. Joe Shannon coming across now. This man whose brother is playing back in the full back line. And Paul Griffin also, of course, is a first cousin of these two players, the Shannons. Shane O'Sullivan is a first cousin, as I said earlier, of Mark O'Connor. So it will really be a very, very big family affair. The Shannons' father, Liam, whom you saw earlier in this production, is a club registrar. Jerome Conway, I can see him across on the far side now. Smiles written all over his face as Danny Cahill, the young Danny Cahill, grabbing this ball now. And fist passing it back into the hands eventually of James O'Shea or of Timmy Fleming. Took the ball too far and referee awards a free out to John Mitchell. There'll be no dilly-dallying here, I'm sure, because time is ticking and ticking. Up on our screen now, it says exactly 21 minutes gone in the game. We leave the watch on your screen now for the remainder of this game. As again, Mitchell's never give up. The spirit of this team is unbelievable. They're bursting forward now again. But again, broken away by the centre half-back, Tommy Johnson. Down into the hands of this man, who unbelievably has got so much pace today. It's just hard to describe it. He's going to score a point here, is he? Yes, indeed, he is not. Rory Kilgannon grabs it nicely. Rory Kilgannon is fouled. Referee says play on advantage as Rory busts forward. A well harassed by Billy Sullivan. Who will get man of the match? It's a burning question. Billy Sullivan has played well. He might get a nod. Time alone will tell. The man on the ball at the moment is Johnny Roach. And Johnny Roach bursting forward again. Some of the crowd are now leaving the ground. But the man who's on the ball now this time is a Mitchell's player. That man, young Johnny Roach. Back to another John Higgins. And John Higgins now, the crowd get behind Mitchell's again. What a goal will do for them to bring him back to life. But it now looks like this game could be gone too far from their reach. We'll have to wait and see. Here comes Johnny Hegarty, he goes for a pint. Johnny's kick off the post, oh what luck. Out to the left and gone harmlessly wide. And Peter Lyons coming out now again. Will this be a proud day for him? Well, time alone will tell. It looks to be that way at the moment now. The ball across on the far side. But Mitchells are not giving up and they're bursting forward again. This time it's the man on the ball is Johnny Roach. Johnny Roach heading out towards the far sideline. Not going anywhere in particular, but he's got the ball in his hand. Playing across in front of goal here, a chance on here. Can they get a score away? Bust Laune Rangers again, but this time grabbing the ball over there on the far side is a Mitchell's man again, and he's a midfield partner, James O'Dowd. James O'Dowd driving it now. Will he have a pot for a point? What will he do? He's driving a high prover up into the sky. The ball breaking about in there, but again a Laune Rangers man grabbing it. There's a free out for Laune Rangers. So far in this senior championship, I told you earlier, on their way to today's final, Laune Rangers had scored a total of 1 goal and 34 points. Against them, had scored a goal and 21 points. You can be adding today's total onto that. Their leading scorer coming up to today's final was Timmy Fleming, having scored 13 points. John Murphy having scored 10, and down it goes like that. Mitchells had scored coming into today's final, believe it or not, 2 goals and 32 points. points. Against them had been scored 3 goals and 20 points, and their leading scorer had been Martin Dennehy, who has been kept very, very quiet today. But Laune Rangers now on the brink of history, on the brink of a night, of a week that will be unbelievable in Killarney. The cup looks like now, bar a miracle, it is going to be going back to Puck Fair, the home of Puck, the home it's going to be of current Bishop Moynihan, as Paul Griffin kicks a marvellous drive, a beautiful sweet point. After 24 and a half minutes of play, the scoreboard now reads 2-9 for Killarney, 4 points for Laune Rangers, up for John Mitchell's got Maleshgale. The kick out is quickly taken by Mitchells out in the middle of the field. The ball is bobbing about. The referee awarding a free kick. And just to recap your memory, the first title Laune Rangers won was back in 1889. They beat that year Killarney Crokes. They next won it again in 1890. On that particular year, they beat John Mitchells, the Trilly Mitchells. But Mitchells come on the attack here now again. A chance of a score here. Nolly Kelleher must score a goal here. It's a marvellous goal by Nolly Kelleher. But has it come too late? Has it come too late to spark a Mitchells revival? Because had he scored the first goal, they would now be within striking distance. I feel it has come too late. 5 minutes left in the game, but time alone will tell. As I was saying, Laune Rangers won the title as well. 1892 they beat Ballymac, 1893 they beat Keel, 1900 was their next title when they beat Killarney Crokes again. Again in 1911 they won the title when they beat Trilly Mitchells in a score of 1-3 to 1-1. That was the last time they won the title. That's bringing them a total of exactly 7 titles. They also won the title in 1887, 1888. But they indeed have been a marvellous team way down the years. A marvellous, fantastic club spirit in their side. And again, the man who's busting forward surely must be coming very, very close to getting man of the match. Billy Sullivan back to Danny Cahill. How fitting that Danny should get his name on the score sheet. Danny, of course, played in the semi-final game. Rough for today's game, but how happy he will be now. How happy the trainer over on the far side will be. Nolo Mahoney, a man who has brought 6 titles. 6 mid-Kerry titles to the club since he took over as their trainer. What a marvellous feat it will be taking this Bishop Moynihan trophy back for him again. The burning question is, will Noel be in school tomorrow? Will Johnny Clifford and will Patsy Joy, will they make their way to work tomorrow? We'll have to wait and see. This man, Danny Cahill, certainly will be available tomorrow, I'm sure, for celebrations. Back to Gerald Murphy. Gerald Murphy's kick is good. Gerald Murphy's kick is straight and through. And now the scoreboard reads 2-11 for Laune Rangers, 1-4 for John Mitchells. The time is ticking and ticking. 26 minutes and 21 seconds gone. Noel, of course, Noel O'Mahony has played for the Laune Rangers team since 1958. He was a minor for the following 2 years and he won a senior championship medal. But Kerry Terry, away come Mitchells again, busting forward. He's got another goal on here. There's not, but there's a point from that man, Johnny Roach. The scoreboard now reads 2-11 to 1-5. Oh my, this has been a final, really and truly. I suppose one could say the second half has been very, very one-sided. But Mitchells, despite the fact of trailing by so much. We've just heard now the attendance has been announced at 11,000 people. I would doubt that very much. It looked to be much bigger than that. But that's the verdict. We have to take it. The time gone in the game, 27 minutes and 10 seconds. It now looks like these men from the lawn are going to take the cup back. And away comes number 17, who is now coming to the game from Laune Rangers. In towards the full forward, number 14. Onto his right foot again, Paddy McKenna. Paddy McKenna's drive is good. And Paddy McKenna's drive has gone over the bar. The number 17, who has come into the field for Laune Rangers, is Paddy Casey. And Paddy Casey is coming. I'm not sure who's gone off. It's a pity they haven't got a microphone system here in Killarney telling us who comes on and who goes off. But that's not the case. It won't worry Laune Rangers as Mitchells burst forward again. And number 20 is in the game for Mitchells. A chance for Mitchells again in front of goal here. Johnny Rose busting forward across to John Joe Sheehy. John Joe Sheehy's drive has gone over the bar and Mitchells are never giving up as number 20 for them comes into the field. That man looks to be John O'Dowd. Oh, this game is looking like, as you can see up on your screen now, it's reading 28 minutes and 13 seconds gone. The time is almost up in a great, marvellous, entertaining county final here in Killarney on Sunday, September 24th, 1989. The time is now 5 past 5. Some of the crowd are leaving the ground. Peter Lyons will be going up any moment now as the proud captain of this great club. to accept the trophy, which will be deserved by all the officers, all the players, all the fans in Killarney, and over faith in this team. Nobody felt they could beat St. Kieran's in the semi-final, the quarter-final, they did that. Many felt they actually beat them in the final, the semi-final, they beat them as well. And here comes the man who came into the field, Paddy Casey, back to Timmy Fleming, and Timmy Fleming's drive is good. There you can see the crowd gathered behind the goals, the Killarney fans gathered in behind the goals now, wondering and waiting. The time gone in the game, exactly 29 minutes. And Rory Kilgannon coming forward once again. He will be sad tonight, I'm sure. But he will be hopeful that maybe Mitchell will come back again to do something. That indeed, I suppose, the fact of Anthony Gleeson having been injured didn't help the situation today. Martin Dini was injured as well, but nobody can take from the fantastic footballing display by Laune Rangers. They've worked as a team, they've played football from the beginning, they've taken many chances that have come their way in the second half, squandered an amount early on in the first half, but they have taken every chance that have come their way in the second half, and for me, that full forward, Billy O'Sullivan, were I to name man of the match, I would be going for him despite the marvellous display outfield, because his goal before half-time was indeed a vital score, coming at a time when it was badly needed, this free kick to be taken by Joe Shannon, and Joe Shannon, will he be reporting tomorrow morning to Pat Healy? In the Allardyce Bank in Dingle, EIB who was part of this final, a marvellous gesture by them, and let's hope they continue to do so for many years to come. As Mitchell's bust forward again now, the time in our watch says time is up in our watch. Referee might allow for injury time as Donald McAvoy bust forward again. Can Mitchell get a consolation goal? That's what would be now. The kick is nice from Nolly Keller out to the right and gone harmlessly wide, and surely now referee Dan Minan, who's had quite a good game, will blow for the final whistle. And the Laune Rangers subs bench will be getting ready to come out. Peter Lyons, the PRO, is in no rush whatsoever. He'll be in some voice tonight. He'll sing some songs. It'll be a great night for James Coffey, a man who has been involved in this club since the early 50s, chairman for nearly 17 years. He's now club treasurer. He won't mind what they spend. The ball is kicked out the middle of the field. There we see them. They're jumping for joy. They're shaking hands all round. Mitchell's players forced to congratulate. It's been a historic day for Laune Rangers. Yes, indeed, a very historic day for Laune Rangers. They take the Bishop Minahan Trophy. They're their fans rushing onto the field. They're going to have some night tonight back there. It's going to make a night, it's going to make a week. A week, I'm sure, of non-stop action. There they are out in the middle, hugging their footballing heroes. And any moment now, we'd see them heading over for the cup presentation. There they are, huddling together. It's been a marvellous occasion, a marvellous footballing occasion. And now we go over for the cup presentation right across on the far side. Magic Quilly puts Mitchell's in a tizzy, that's what the Laune Rangers fans are saying. And here they come now, very, very happy indeed with this marvellous achievement. Their captain now, Peter Lyons, making his way over here to accept this trophy.
And down the step, a man of God, they're going on for the final. The man on the club bottom bridge is the goal. Without any doubt, this was a most historic day in the annals of the Kerry County Board. For the first time for many years, we had two top teams competing in the county senior football championship final. We had Laune Rangers who weren't seen in the final since 1911. That wonderful team, John Mitchels, for the first time since 1966.
You must take on that flag there. You can take on that flag there, will you?
And of course, here in my right hand, I hold the trophy which will be respected and fought for many years to come. The wonderful new Bishop Marahin Cup. I would like to thank everybody associated with the county championship, all the teams who played here today, the show steering committee, referees and umpires, the media and everybody who contributed. I want to pay special tribute to John Mitchell's sponsoree. As I said, it was our first time in the finals in 66, and indeed this was our first time getting beyond the semi-final since that year. They bring great colour and excitement to a final which only they can bring. They battled bravely to the very end, and I know that they will be receiving this trophy and bringing back to their fine Dublins in a year or two. I thank the John Mitchells for being great sportsmen. For the men from the Laune, they set their hearts. Prince of Kerry for 1989.
Team effort, like, you know, from goalkeeper to subs that came on, like, you know, you couldn't ask for any more of the players.
At what stage in the game do you feel comfortable enough that you did one?
Cheers, Pat. They were 2 points over. They got 2 points back at us after half time, but we rattled away. We got 4 or 5 points. We got about 4 points to the trot then, and our forwards were playing as a unit, and it came through. Billy Sutton got the goal then, of course. The boys got a goal back, but 78 years to wait for this. It's tremendous, like, you know. We don't work for a week anyway.
Hope you Peter enjoyed it. Well done.
Thanks very much.
Here I have the chairman of the Laune Rangers Club, and I suppose I needn't tell you he's in absolutely fantastic form at the moment. Jerome, congratulations.
Thank you very much, Paddy.
What's the feeling like?
Fantastic relief is how I feel at the moment. We have worked for 20 years at this, and I must say that there were times when we did have self-doubts. Fellas would say to you, where are all your young fellas gone? Why aren't they coming through? Why aren't they coming through to win a championship? And there were times when we did have self-doubts, but it all came together today.
Now, at any stage during the game today, like, did you feel a bit worried? Or will, let's say, at what stage in the game did you feel that the title was going back to the Laune?
Yeah, well, we did feel a bit worried. We were leading by 4 points at half-time, and then they came back and got 2 points, and they seemed to be on top of midfield. But then once George Shannon came into it again in the middle of the field, and Timmy Fleming, and the forwards kicked into action, Jordan Murphy kicked some beautiful points, and the rest of the forwards worked like blazes. I knew then... and of course, when Swatsby kind of got the goal, it was on its way over the Laune. after 78 years.
No, any truth in the rumour that all the schools are closing at least for tomorrow and Tuesday, Jerome?
Not officially, but unofficially, as I say, there'll be very few officers around tomorrow.
Okay, Jerome, well done and enjoy the celebration.
Thank you very much, Paddy. Thanks for
I have Liam Shannon, whom you saw earlier in our production, and as well as being the club registrar, he's the father of two sons on the team. Well, Liam, how are you feeling after that? Fantastic.
Fantastic feeling, Paddy. I just cannot describe it at this time at all. Cannot describe it. Really fantastic to have two of them there to win two county championship medals.
Now, at what stage in the game did you feel, well, it's home and drive, we have it?
Well, no, I thought that just before half-time, the goal, just before half-time, I thought that was the turning point. I said once we get that, go in at half-time with that lead, and we're unsung then after that.
Now, do you feel that if Nolly Keller had scored that goal about 8 minutes before he got his first goal, that it might have made a difference at that stage?
I think we were playing that well at the time, you know, that we could come back. We were playing with great confidence.
It's going to make a good week in Killarney.
Going to make a very good week, Paddy, a very good week.
And it's going to make a very long night, I will say, tonight.
It will make a long night and a long day tomorrow.
Okay, Liam, enjoy it and well done again.
Thank you very much.
I suppose a man that needs no introduction whatsoever, John Evans, coach of the minor team who won the championship just over a week ago, and here today seeing his senior side bringing off the county title. John, what does it feel like?
Absolutely brilliant. They were fantastic out there. From start to finish, they worked, and this is the one thing that we were worried about all year. Would they work for the hour? And I think there is no doubt about it. They proved it. They were a fitter team, more determined, and above all, they were disciplined on the field of play. And that was very important to us. Joe Shannon was absolutely tremendous. He caught everything, started, kept it going right throughout the hour, and he supplied ball to the forwards. Our backs held tight, and you can see what the Mitchell scored from play. Our backs were superb. They played with great heart, and the main thing, there was unity out there on that field today. And with that, I think came their fighting ability, and they stayed at it for the hour. We were the team that were worried about all year that we wouldn't stay at it for the hour, but this time we start with determination. We built slowly. Sullivan came with a fantastic goal, and then we started rolling in the second half. It was great, great feeling. We waited a long time for it, and I'm a very, very proud man at the moment.
Any truth in the rumour, John, that you were on a fairly big retainer for bringing the game here to Killarney, actually, John?
Well, I got a lot of stick for it, we'll say, in Tralee, as I'm working there now. But I was doing what the club instructed me to do. And indeed, the county board can look at it now from the way people could see the game here today. We had well over 11,000 people at this game. That was came through the gates, but definitely to me there was 15,000 people here today. And the county board will have to realise that you must accommodate people with their parking, how they could bring their families here today and see a thoroughly enjoyable game.
Okay, John, have a good night, and I'm sure you will.
We will indeed.
With me, I suppose, one of the proudest, one of the happiest men here today, Michael O'Donnell. Well, Michael, you believed you could do it all along, didn't you?
Well, I knew that we could do it because we had the team, and we had the best team that's in this part of Kerry, and I hope next year we'll be back again. And I told them Friday night, we're not from any other county, we're from the town of Killarney, and I think I said a few prayers, and I said I went to mass, and I lighted a couple of candles, and that's what did the job from today.
Okay, Michael, well done again, have a nice night. And just out of the shower, I think he's going to go back in a moment, but a man is in fantastic form, Michael. Your congratulations and well done.
Thank you.
At what stage in the game did you feel that you could relax and that you felt you had it?
I never thought about relaxing, to be honest with this. I did not know the score. I still don't know the final score. We could be 1 point down, 1 point up. I honestly did not know the score.
No, coming into today's game, how did you feel about taking on the Mitchell? Did you feel that you had more than a 50-50 chance?
I felt extremely relaxed, because all week I was talking with Vincent Evans, and he gave me a few shots for this old broken bone on my wrist there. And besides that, Mitchell's base is now last holding by 9 points. And I knew in my hat and soul we weren't 9 points worse than him. Like, we have tremendous players outside, the likes of Jordan Murphy, Paul Griffin, Billy Sullivan. That proved it today, in all fairness to him. As I said inside, that wasn't a game. So we didn't play a game. So we played exhibition stuff today, in all fairness.
Okay, Joe, have a wonderful week. I'm sure you will. It's going to make a long night tonight, you think?
It'll make a long week.
Well done, Joe. Well done. No, with me. Right. Are you on? Now, with me here, I have Patsy Joy, one of the Killarney senior selectors, and a very happy man indeed. Patsy, well done.
Thanks very much.
At what stage in the game did you feel that it looked like you were going to take it back past the Laune River?
I felt just before half-time when Billy Sullivan hit that goal just before half-time.
No, you had missed a lot of chances early on in the first half. Did you think you'd be regretting those?
No, we were we were playing too well in the middle of the field, and our full back line, our whole six backs were playing extremely well.
It must have been very hard for you to decide to bring in subs. I know that everybody had been playing so well, but it was just a matter of giving the lads a game,
that's
was
right.
It?
That's the reason, yeah. We have a panel of 27, like, and we had to pick out 18, like, and that's the way it went.
Did you feel kind of nervous in the build-up to the game yourself today?
Oh, yeah, it was all nerves all the week, like, you know, it was worse to be a selector than a player, I think.
And how's the hat ticking at this stage?
Oh, it's still gone to the other side.
Well done, have a good night. Disappointed, John Mitchell's team captain, John Joe Sheehy. Well, John Joe, what you felt happened to you on the day, John Joe?
Felt we were a bit dead on our feet today, but in all fairness, we were beaten by a much better side. They played very, very well. I was very impressed with Jordan Murphy, man of the match. All your stars played very well for you, and there was no hard feelings there. You were beaten by a better team on the day, and maybe next year we might give you a better game.
At what stage in the game, John Joe, did you feel it has slipped from your grasp?
I thought we held you well in the first half, except for Billy's goal. Great goal too, just on the interval. We came back then and started second half. I think we picked up two handy points. And I thought we were in, you know, scoring distance again from you. But you just kind of stepped up back here, put into overdrive, and slipped away from us. You know, it was a very one-sided game. You were very, very strong, and congratulations to them. You know, they played a great game.
Okay, John Joe, thank you very much. The third selector on this Laune Rangers team, John. Sum up the way you're feeling for me at the moment.
Well, what do you say, like, after a performance like that, fantastic altogether, you know, they gave a brilliant second half performance, particularly in the second half, you know, fantastic.
You played as an absolute and complete team unit. Was that worked on hard in training?
But we've been working on that, you know, it's part of our plan and training, to the teamwork, you know, takes precedence all the time.
No, you have a very young side, a side there that's capable, one would imagine, of coming back again and possibly even retaining this title.
Yeah, basically, they're a very young side, apart from, you know, there's only three or four fellas. And apart from that, you know, most of them are young enough for a couple of more years, even the older fellas, you know. Right. There's a few more years than the older fellas all the time.
So it's going to make a big night tonight?
Hopefully.
And congratulations again, and thanks a million.
Okay.
Right, Paul Griffin, how are you feeling after that?
Unbelievable. I feel great. Massive altitude. I never thought it would happen this day, like, you know. We waited a long time and it's coming out, like. Hopefully we'll be back here again next year.
Did you feel very nervous before the game?
Not really, no. I knew, like, if we played well, I thought if our forwards got going at all, we got our shooting boots on, like, we would get it together, like, and we did. And I thought Josh had a great game. It feel like, even though his hand was in doubt up to the last few minutes of the game, he had to get an injection in his hand, like, you know. He played a massive game, like, you know, and I think he brought us through in the finish.
Do you feel now, Paul, that having made the breakthrough and having won this first one, that it's going to stand you in a big way? And this is a young team, isn't it?
Very young team, yeah. Especially, like, you know, there's eight of that team under 21, like, this year, and I think we'll be around for a while now, like, you know, hopefully. We got the breakthrough now, and we'll be here again next year.
Well done again, Paul. Well done. Must be a fantastic feeling after that.
Yeah, very nice party indeed. We're delighted to win, yes.
After all the hard work and the, I mean, since 83 you've won six mid-Kerry championships, but this must be really the sweetest feeling of all, is it?
Ah, yeah, this is the best one of all, yeah. You know, we're a long time waiting for it, 78 years, and it's very nice to win. You know,
no, coming into the game this morning and getting up this morning and doing your normal Sunday morning chores, how did you feel? Did you feel a bit on the nervous side?
No, indeed. I tell you, a little bit nervous, but I think we were more nervous before the first round and the semi-finals. You know, whatever it is about the final today, we were not as nervous coming to the game today. You know, I can't explain it, but that's the way it was, you know. We were.
No, that's a very young side you have, and a side that has done a lot of work, and a side that it looks like could be around for quite a while again.
Yes, we have a nice blend of experienced players and young players, but, you know, anything can happen. You know, it's nice to win one, and I would not like to make any predictions beyond that, you know.
Any truth in the rumour that the department had given you the week off?
No, they might give me one day.
Anyway, well,
or I might take it.
You might take it anyway. Well done again, congratulations, and have a great night.
Thanks very much, Paddy.
How are you feeling after that?
Well, Paddy, when I spoke to the last night, I'll be quite honest with you, we weren't half as confident as we had to be, but thanks be to God, today went perfect. You could only dream about a result like today. Forwards were magnificent in the second half, backs did what they had to do, and midfield were outstanding. So, under today's performance, I don't think we could be beaten, and that's the spirit that's going right down through the Laune Rangers from under 12 down. That's our spirit, that's the way we play it, and if we win some and lose some, that's the look of the draw, but today we came out on top.
Well done.
Thanks, Paddy.
Tom Johnson had a marvellous game. Did you feel at any stage during the game, did you feel in danger?
They're not really. I think of our backs played well in the first half, like, which they did, you know. We closed them down quick, like, and kept the scores down, like, you know. And that was it, like, we did. I think we did, you know, if we played them well in the second half, then, like, we'd have won, you know. Our forwards, like, we topped our forwards, you know, they got great scores in the second half, you know. They ran the backs right. I don't think Mitchell's any answer to them, like. There's a few teams that have an answer to our forwards today, like, you know. The ball was played to open space and they ran onto it, like, you know, and they put the ball over the bar, like, you know. There's no answer to that, like.
Now, you trained very hard for this, long and trained hard, and you played together winning six mid-Kerry Championship titles. Would this be the greatest day in your footballing career, would you say?
Oh, I'd say so, by far, yeah. By far, yeah. We have the Bishop going in the bridge tonight, like, that's about our aim for the last, since 1911, you know. Every fellow's dream, like, you know, and there's a lot of good footballs went before, I never got a chance, like, you know. We're privileged, I mean, like, to be here today, like, representing Laune Rangers in the county final, and win it. That was after good football teams went before and didn't get this star, you know.
No, what's the plan for the remainder of the evening, Tom?
We're going to Castleisland now for a meal, that's it, and we'll see it and, like, take it by ear after that, you know.
Any truth in the rumour that Gareth Evans has okayed pubs to be open for the next week non-stop?
No truth in the world, no.
Well done again and congratulations.
Thanks very much.
With me, Anthony Shannon, a direct from Casualand in Killarney, and as you can see, they're looking very well, the Killarney team, all rigged out in a beautiful rig out today, blazer, pants, a shirt and tie. Well, Anthony, how are you feeling after that?
Oh, fantastic. Over the moon. Delighted to win this trophy. We trained very hard, a lot of the lads to be on the team today. We've been playing football for Laune Rangers from age 5 to age 10, and today was an all-honour final to us. It was great to win. And for the lads, only 5 or 6 of us, I'd say we're probably looking at retirement probably after this game, but I think we might hold on for another year.
Now, how did you feel out there on the pitch? Was the pitch in great condition for playing?
Oh, it's fabulous. It's fabulous. I played in Croke Park, and they said it's second to Croke Park. It's one of the best. I said just to walk on the field out today with the supporters that we had out today was unbelievable. I said there's not a sinner left in Killarney.
The support from Killarney was absolutely fantastic. Now, what's the population, if you need, approximately, of Killarney?
Well, it proved out today about the population. There was none left in Killarney.
The county board said there was approximately 11,000. Would you reckon there was more than that?
I reckon myself, I just reckon the start of the week, I was reckoning about 15,000 people. And I said, our own town, we had big support, and we had a lot of support. Home from England, from America, even from Canada. And I said, that's all the support that we had. And I think there was at least about 16,000 people out today. There must have been.
Now, one final question. Will your shop be open tomorrow, Anthony?
Well, it'll be open, I won't be working. Thanks very much. Thank you.
Well, James, congratulations. Fantastic achievement.
Thanks very much, Paul. Great achievement. I thought, you know, that we do, but quietly, I was saying to the boys that it was a 50-50 game, but I know once we were on top of midfield that we had no trouble. It was only a matter of time when our forwards would shake off the, you know, of excitement was, and I suppose the tension, and when they did, they really cut loose. It was just what I expected from them.
Now, your club has been involved in fantastic underage success right over a long period of years, and it has taken you until this time to get through. Now, having made that breakthrough, can you see yourself staying at the top for quite a while?
Well, I'm satisfied now that we've won one. The boys said that they can go on and win 2 and 3. Probably they win, they're all young enough. We've plenty of stuff coming up. That's looking, I was sitting with the reserves there on the bench and looking around me, I said that they could have brought on maybe another team and have done the same thing. So it'll take time. Noel Mann, he's a fantastic man. He had a fantastic way with him. People didn't agree with his selection today, maybe, and his fellow selectors, but it worked out that he was right. He's the man for all seasons, as I'm concerned, anyway.
Now, James, what's your plan for the remainder of, I won't say the day, but the remainder of the week? You probably won't open the hall this week, will you?
Well, we'll go according to plan, and that is that every man live it up. We only get this chance once in a lifetime, and I think that once we get out there to cook tonight, it will be really hell let loose.
Okay, James, congratulations, and well done again. A very nice little story here. We have two very important medals here, right in front of us. They bring back a lot of memories, and with me here, Chrissy Reardon will tell us first about his one.
Well, that's the father there, and that's the medal. The last time this was won was 1911, as you all know, and indeed, this is the medal, and of course, it'll be called a holy medal after today, because I was printed all through the second half. Still not the longest of a football medal, but it's a holy medal, and indeed, delighted, like everybody else, and the Baptist.
James, is medal over here?
This is the first county championship Laune Rangers won in 1889. It was won by Jimmy Dyle with Laune Rangers, and his granddaughter, Honor O'Connor, arrived down 10 minutes before I left with it as a lucky woman. So, that's it.
So hopefully you wanted to wait for that long again to win a county title.
Next year again.
Well done again, lads, well done.
Bye.
Our man of the match for today, Gerard Murphy and Tommy Woods, club secretary. First of all, both of you, lads, well done and congratulations anyway. Gerard, we'll start with you first. You had a very unhappy memory here going back in 1984. All that changed today, didn't it?
Did, yeah. Nice comeback to this pitch. Oh, I like this pitch. Yeah, it suits our game, wide open. And sure, today we didn't have full forward line, no amount of space they had. I had a Billy, the great game inside there. Plus, when the midfield and halfbacks were on top, you know, there was plenty of room to play the ball into. And it was a change for us, really, to play the ball. We usually kind of hold it up in the middle of the field, where today we just let it go and it worked out great. Like, the scoreboard showed it.
No, I was amazed, as I marked in the commentary, I was amazed at the amount of room you got. How did you get so much room? Was it because you were roaming everywhere, or was it because a man couldn't just stay with you?
No, I just, the way it worked out today, I was surprised, really. It was it's a big pitch, and I was surprised that I got so much room early in the game. I don't think I got it built at all in the first half, but in the second half they tightened up, all right. But I don't know, I don't honestly know what happened. I think Robert Dow might have been injured, I don't know.
So you're looking forward to a good night tonight, anyway, and a big day at the function tomorrow?
Yeah, hopefully.
Congratulations on your win and on your man of the match again, and enjoy.
Thanks very much, Paddy.
Tommy.
Paddy.
How are you feeling after that?
I feel great. I feel great feeling. I feel particularly pleased, like, for the people who've been involved with the club for a long time. The older officers, people like James Coffey, who's 46 years involved with the club. And great also for the older players, Tom Johnson, James Sheehan, Anthony Shannon. These men have been there 10 years, and they've worked hard for this. And I feel very pleased for them.
It's going to make a big week.
It'll shorten the winter, I think.
Do you think you're capable of looking after that fine cup worth £6,000?
We will look after it, don't worry, and we'll keep it again for a few years, hopefully.
Okay, Tommy, well done again, enjoy your night. Well done. Bart, what's this going to mean for football in Killarney?
Well, I think it's going to be a tremendous boost to football in Killarney. As you know, down the years, people have been doing great work for all grades, from, we'll say, under 12 upwards, and indeed you could say from under 7 upwards. And this win on the county championship today is going to be a tremendous boost to all those people, and it will be a great incentive for the young people of the Killarney parish to continue playing football, as those players gave a great account of themselves out there. The sportsmanship was fantastic, and I think they're great ambassadors to any of our young people.
Okay, Bart, well done again, congratulations, and have a great week.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you very much.
There we have it, the final word from Bart Moriarty. As you can see, Fitzgerald Stadium in Killarney is now empty. We see the sign from our sponsors as we bade you farewell on this very historic Sunday, September 24th, 1989. Good evening, Cadlaw Ella, Sloan, Grib, Galair.